Partly cloudy and 22 today with the 6 o'clock news. Good morning, I'm Graham Goodings.
Physio, Pilates, hydro, massage, podiatry and exercise classes. Physio Extra's holistic care. Physioextra.com.
The by-election battle for Dunstan has taken another turn. Labour candidate Cressida O'Hanlon has claimed she had nothing to do with her husband's business, Citadel Secure, despite being listed on the website as a senior associate. It follows questions about Liberal candidate Anna Fenizio's links to a failed family business, Formway Group. Dunstan voters will go to the polls this Saturday. The World Meteorological Organization says global heat records were smashed in 2023. In its annual State of the Climate report, the UN agency says temperatures were now getting dangerously close to the 1.5 degree limit agreed to at the climate summit in Paris. Head of the WMO, Celeste Saulo, says 2023 was the warmest year on record.
It is imperative that our actions today are based on the welfare of future generations rather than short-term economic interests. I am now sounding the red alert about the state of the climate.
Meantime, Australia's ongoing climate policy will be on the agenda in Canberra today when a range of experts gather. The Climate Integrity Summit will bring together economists, academics, parliamentarians and traditional owners. Australia Institute Climate and Energy Director Polly Hemming says climate conversation is vital as we draw closer to a federal election.
Climate and integrity were key themes of the 2022 election, and I think they've only become more important for the Australian community. The summit really is an opportunity to see how we're tracking.
Three boys, the youngest just 13, will front court today over a crime series involving half a dozen cars. Mel Archer reports.
It's been revealed a Porsche and Mercedes stolen from Leabrook yesterday and later found dumped at Gillis Plains were part of a crime series. They've been linked to four other cars taken from various addresses since last Friday. A Mitsubishi Eclipse, Volkswagen Jetta, Kia Sorato and Land Rover Discovery were stolen from properties in Lightsview, Paraka and St George's. Those four cars are yet to be recovered. Three boys, a 13-year-old from Dufferin Park, 15-year-old from Holden Hill and 16-year-old from Flinders Park, have been charged with illegal use of a motor vehicle, the two older boys further charged with attempted aggravated serious criminal trespass. They'll appear in the youth court today.
Regional security, trade and human rights will be on the agenda during the Chinese Foreign Minister's visit to Australia. Zach De Silva has more.
China's top diplomat is in Canberra today for talks with his counterpart, Penny Wong. It's the first time Wang Yi has been in Australia since 2017. Senator Wong says there will be a frank exchange on issues like regional security. Consular matters are also on the agenda, likely including the plight of Australian writer Yang Hengjun, who's facing the death penalty in China. Mr. Wang will also meet with the opposition, business leaders and former Labor Prime Minister Paul Keating.
And now turning to 5AA Sport.
Agostino Mitsubishi's Good To Go giveaway is on now. Receive a bonus $1,000 fuel card on 2023 Build Outlander.
And here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Port Adelaide legend Travis Boak is preparing to play his 350th game this weekend when the Power takes on Richmond at the MCG. It's been an incredible journey for the 35-year-old, who had a big offer to leave the club for Geelong when the Power was on its knees. He decided to stay, and he told Fox Footy he wasn't the only one at the time who wanted to see things through at Alberton.
Look, I'm not the only one that stayed around during the dark times. You know, like Robbie and Jackson Trengove at the time and a few others really stood by the club. And
meantime, Hawthorn captain James Sicily's one-game ban for kicking has been downgraded to a fine. That's after fronting the tribunal last night. A high-profile Olympian has suggested Brisbane could be the host city that kills the Olympics. The harsh words come as politicians wrangle over the stadiums needed to host the 2032 event. The Queensland Premier is ignoring an independent report and instead backing the old Queensland Sport and Athletics Centre. But with a capacity of just 40,000, it would make it the smallest athletics venue since 1928. Olympic swimmer Liesl Jones saying she fears for the future of the Games.
I am actually quite concerned that Brisbane could be the city that kills the Olympics. If a country like Australia is going to be struggling to put on a Games that is worthy of showing the world, we need to question if we are struggling to do the Games, who else can do the Games? Because if we're struggling to do it, are those countries going to look at us and say, well, how the hell are we supposed to do it?
Audio thanks to SCA, and that is the 5AA Sport.
And now the 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video, direct to you from your AutoMaster's technician.
Partly cloudy and 22 today, tomorrow sunny 24, Friday sunny 24, Saturday sunny 25. Currently, the coldest day for some time, it's just 13 degrees. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Don't miss the legendary Gladys Knight for one last time as the Empress of Soul returns to Australia in 2024 for a final celebration of soul. Witness Gladys Knight perform all her greatest hits live on stage at Festival Theatre Adelaide on Thursday, March 21. Gladys Knight, the farewell tour. Tickets on sale now at Ticketek. Presented by MG Live, Frontier Touring and Arena Touring.
Fresh nuts, melt-in-your-mouth chocolates and eye-popping Easter gifts. G'day folks, I'm Brett Charlesworth and there are three irresistible reasons to visit Charlesworth Nuts and make your family's Easter extra special. And here's three more. We're South Australian, we're fourth generation and still family owned, and on the Tuesday before Easter, Charlesworth Nuts turns 90 years young. You're always welcome at our 11 family owned stores or shop online. Why Charlesworth? Because fresh nuts taste better.
The Adelaide Hills are most certainly alive. There are so many new families now making the tree change, and these people enjoy the space. They seek change. They've chosen to discover what is on the road less travelled. And if you're heading up to the hills from the freeway, take the Bridgewater exit and soon you'll be discovering the home of Nissan in the hills.
Now, for all of you adventure seekers, we've got an incredible deal for you. If you've got your eyes on a Navara or a Patrol, stock's available for immediate delivery with a free 3-hour off-road course at Adelaide Hills 4-wheel drive park. T's and C's apply.
Take the road less travelled to Nissan's home in the hills and check out their off-road sale. Adelaide Hills Nissan since 1954, Mount Barker Road, Bridgewater.
It's Ian Healy, and I'm here to talk to you about back pain and Kiza. If you're one of the 80% of Australians who suffer from back pain, it's tempting to do nothing, but this can cause weaknesses down the road. The best place to start with back pain is exercise, and the best place to exercise is Kiza. Kiza's physios and Swiss-designed strength training equipment help you build strength in a supervised environment. I go to Kiza and you can too at our new clinic in Norwood. Book your initial assessment at kiza.com.au.
The news and issues that matter to South Australia.
Always Adelaide.
This is 5AA.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
8 minutes after six. Good morning to you. Welcome to Wednesday on 5AA Breakfast. Big morning ahead, actually, today. Sean Fuster will join us. We'll go around the courts with Sean. David Kosh on the program. What a week for the AFL. Welcoming, perhaps, the newest franchise in Tasmania, so long as the election in a couple of days doesn't scuttle things. We'll get Koshy's thoughts on that and the RBA's decision yesterday to put rates on hold. Josh Rochelli, talk about, I usually say a tale of two halves in football. It was a tale of 3.5 quarters. Josh Rochelli turned it on. He almost snatched the game victory from the jaws of defeat up there in the Gold Coast. Wasn't to be, but we'll chat with him about the game at 8.20 today. And also, the biggest, I think, issue that's been bubbling on in the background, it burbles to the surface every morning at about 6.40 when we chat with SAPOL. The police commissioner is going to join us to talk crime in the city, talk about the patrols on along Rundle Mall, and some of the other issues that are going on with regards to small businesses being targeted and a spate of these sorts of issues at the moment. So stick around for the police commissioner after 8.30 today. David Penberthy, good morning to you.
Good morning, listeners. Good morning, Will. That's such a feel-good story, the Tasmanian football team, the Mighty Devils, yet to play a game. Who knows when they will. Some might even say, who knows if they ever will.
I just feel like I don't want to get excited until this weekend.
No.
Until the politics is the other way.
Well, that's right. Tasmania goes to the polls this Saturday. The Greens are against the stadium being built under, and Labor are also against the stadium being built along the funding model as currently envisaged, with the AFL largely handing the cost to the taxpayers. The Libs have said they're going to go ahead with the stadium, but Tasmanian politics, it's got a different voting system to ours, proportional representation, and it means it's almost impossible for anyone to have a majority. The only time, I don't really follow that closely, but apart from like the early days of that Robin Gray guy who ended up getting knocked off because of the Franklin River dispute, It's very rare to have an ascendant Tasmanian premier.
Yeah. Well, it's like the same system as I think New Zealand has the Hare Clark system, and a lot of European countries work on that premise as well.
Yeah.
But it does make it difficult.
But doesn't it show? So Tasmania, right, population about a bit over 500,000, so half a million people. As within less than 24 hours, 100,000 Tasmanians have paid $10 each to become foundation members of the Tasmanian Devils. One in five people.
Yeah.
I mean, there's probably a few on the mainland have done it as well. There'd be a few mainlanders. Some people might have done it just for the love of the game, who aren't Tasmanian, got no link to Tasmania.
Well, there'd be a lot of expat Tasmanians, wouldn't there, that don't vote?
Oh, so many. Well, it's sort of like the New Zealand of Australia, isn't it? Because so many people come to the mainland for work reasons. Have we got any lapsed Tasmanians who listen to our show? We'd have Tasmanian-born listeners, heaps of them, I reckon.
Yeah, I reckon we definitely would.
How do you feel about guys? 8223-0000. But don't you reckon the fact that there's been this inordinate sort of hand-wringing about it by everyone in Tasmanian politics, and the whole vibe of it, when you read political coverage out of Tasmania, is, well, this potentially is the worst thing that could ever happen to Tasmania. And the moment memberships go on sale, one in five people buy them. It shows there's a huge disconnect between what people in politics think and what the normal people think.
Yeah, I'll be interested to see how that plays out politically on the weekend, whether the Liberals get a big boost as the party that has championed this the most. I think that'll be fascinating. It feels like a line in the sand moment for Tassie in a sort of a bigger how do you see yourself sense as well. Like, if you want big stuff and you want to be part of playing with the big boys and get a big footy team in town, you got to pay some money.
Yeah, totally.
Like, you got to swallow hard sometimes.
Well, we showed that with the Adelaide Oval. And I know there's still people.
Looks like a bargain by comparison.
God bless you, Matt Abraham. There's still people who go, why the taxpayers have to pay so much of the bill? Well, it's like, why the taxpayers have to pay so much of the bill for everything? You know, like, it's just what we do. But it's almost like, it's like the equivalent of, as a private family going, you know, we could actually set up a trust so that all of our money that we would ever spend on anything is held in perpetuity for our children and our grandchildren. And we could make sure that the wiring in the house is in tip-top nick, and we've got Clipsal safety switches everywhere, and we could get the gutters done, because I noticed a few months ago that there's a bit of a gap on the veranda. Or we could go, you know what we're going to do? We're all going to go on a bloody great holiday. And we're going to create memories. We're going to have so much fun as a family, that we're going to remember this for the rest of our lives. You know, you need to do, if you can, you need to do that sort of stuff. And I'd say, as a country, we can afford to do things like that. I mean, look at Haiti at the moment. You know, that's a country that, you know, poor godforsaken joint. But Australia, we can fund things like that without the collapse or unjustifiable sort of rundown of other key services. Don't you reckon?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we get carried away with some of the budget bottom line figures and carried over debt and, you know, short-term deficit numbers and so forth. But if you look in a global sense, it's all a pittance. The country does really well. We're a rich, very well-off country.
And I do sometimes wonder whether the people who arc up about this just sort of scratch the surface and deep down they're sort of like, well, I'm not having any fun, and I don't see anybody else should either. The sort of, was it Karl Marx who said, religion is the opiate of the people? And, you know, others say that about sport.
Yeah. I think it's probably a hard sell to your Greens base. if you're a Greens politician, so.
I don't want to sound biased, but they can go and get stuff.
Yeah, but they can't in Tasmania.
Well, that's true. You're beholden to them.
Exactly. Yeah.
Well, it's the ultimate sort of tree change place, isn't it?
It is a beautiful place.
Since 1983, you know, it's had that. You know, we went there on a family holiday from the mainland, obviously, when the dams dispute was underway. Dad had there was a biochemist's conference down there that he had to go at when he was working at Flinders. And it was in the absolute thick of the dams dispute. And he couldn't get us meals in a pub, counter meals in a pub in Strawn. because he always had this beard, and he always looked like he was not a hippie, but he had a beard. And we're out of town, as in Strawn, huge logging community, massively pro the dam going ahead. And we ordered some battered scallops and some seafood. And after like 40 minutes, the meal hasn't come out. Dad goes over and says, "Oh, just wondering if there's any sign of the food." And this bloke just goes, "You'll get it when you get it." Like this.
Yeah.
And they never served us. And we just had to leave.
Really? Yeah. Well, they thought he was some sort of greenie protester.
Mainland greenie down there to cause trouble.
They might have sniffed you out. This is pre-Occupy Wall Street days, wasn't it?
Well, I was actually into the dams dispute.
Mm. Yeah, I think they took one look at you and here we go. We've got a troublemaker here.
It was amazing. It was such an amazing... Yeah. It was an amazingly divisive time. But, you know, part of it was... It's the home of the loggers, but it's also the home of Bob Brown.
Mm.
You know, it's a hugely diverse place politically. Mm. Fascinating place, isn't it?
Certainly is. It'll be interesting to see what plays out over the course of the next few days. 16 after 6, we're going to take a quick break.
One other thing. You know, in Mexico, when someone's vanished, you say, like we say, metaphorically, you haven't seen someone for a long time.
Yeah, right.
Like you say, they've fallen off the face of the earth. Mm. Or when we talk about Timbuktu, as if it's this mythical, far-off land. In Mexico, they say, "Oh, I haven't seen him for so long, I think he's gone to Tasmania." And when one of my mates at school said it to me when I was there, I said, "What are you saying about Tasmania?" He said, "Tasmania? What about Tasmania?" I said, "Tasmania's in Australia." And this guy looked at me, he's just laughing, he's going, "Tasmania's not anywhere." I'm going, "It is a state, it's one of the 6 states of Australia." And he's going, "Really?" It was like a total revelation for him.
It was their Timbuktu.
Yeah, it's their Timbuktu, Tasmania. He's gone to Tasmania.
17 minutes after 6, news headlines coming up in just a moment.
G'day, Roey here. Take it from me. Yamaha motors are the best in the world, and the best time to get one is now. Upgrade your existing boat or power up a new boat with a new Yamaha outboard. Right now, you'll save up to $1,300. That's $10 off for every unit of horsepower across their 30 to 130 horsepower range. Get more horsepower for less bucks. Visit your local Yamaha marine dealer today. Conditions apply. Promotion ends May 31.
Are painful muscle cramps ruining your workout or waking you up at night? If you're low on magnesium, you can get painful muscle cramps or mild muscle spasms. Caruso's vitamin K2 plus D3 plus magnesium contains 6 types of magnesium in a time-release formula to reduce and relieve muscle cramps when your dietary intake is inadequate. It also supports bone strength, muscle function and heart health. Caruso's vitamin K2 plus D3 plus magnesium is available from leading pharmacies and health stores. Always read the label and follow the directions for use.
Are you ready for bigger, better, healthier flowers, fruits and veggies? At Kennard Self Storage in Theberton, Vasili's pop-up garden shop is here. Vasili's products that will transform your garden and you'll save because all stock must be sold at reduced prices. And you get to meet Vasili. Hurry this week only. 103 Port Road, Theberton at Kennards. Just ask at reception for Vasili's pop-up garden shop and they'll point you in the right direction. To find out more, visit vasilisgarden.com. Hurry, must end Sunday.
It's Edward here from Edwardstown Mazda.
Thanks, Edward. I've got this. And it's big news.
How big?
Really big. Edwardstown Mazda have extended their sale with huge Mazda factory bonuses across a wide range of Mazdas. Plus, get a $2,000 trade-in bonus on top of your trade-in price. Only available at Edwardstown Mazda.
Wow.
I know, right? Wow.
Plays a jingle scene.
It's gotta be.
Edwardstown Mazda. T's and C's apply.
At Lordman and Pank, we offer a wide range of premium Essilor lenses to meet your individual needs. Shop today for $150 off selected digital progressive lenses. Offer ends April 3. T's and C's apply. See website for details. Lordman and Pank, we care for eyes.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
90 minutes after 6, news headlines time on this Wednesday, the 20th of March. China's top diplomat is visiting Australia for the first time since 2017. Foreign Minister Wang Yi will sit down with his counterpart, Penny Wong, to discuss issues including trade and regional security. Senator Wong is promising a frank exchange of views during the talks. He needn't worry, though, Wang Yi, because I think he's also catching up with Paul Keating, who'll get a frank exchange of agreement.
Oh, yeah, he's got a bit of a tummy tickle from old PJK.
It's been revealed a Porsche and Mercedes stolen from the eastern suburbs yesterday and later found dumped at Gillis Plains were part of a series of crimes. They've been linked to four cars stolen from various addresses in the past 5 days. Three boys have been arrested. The youngest, just 13, from Davern Park.
Wow.
As well as a 15-year-old from Holden Hill and a 16-year-old from Flinders Park. They've been charged with illegal use of a motor vehicle. The two older boys were further charged with attempted aggravated serious criminal trespass. There'll be a court appearance today.
Aggravated criminal trespass that suggests it was a home invasion.
Yeah, they broke into someone's home and stole
the keys,
were there. I guess. Yeah. Yeah, if it's aggravated, it means people were there, doesn't it?
I think so. Terrifying. And the oldest was 16.
The oldest was 16.
Jeez.
Youngest just 13. See what a 13-year-old kid looks like? You would know. Mm. You've had a couple of
yeah,
them.
Yeah, totally.
They're so young.
Yeah.
They're just...
They are. They're like...
They're babies.
You're still at that age where you're sort of half teenage and then suddenly yeah. you have these little moods where you just act like a little kid again.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, it's just crazy. Year 9, isn't it? Year 10.
Sorry, no. Younger, yeah. Year 8. Yeah.
Year 8. Hmm.
A library in Massachusetts has been inundated with photos of cats. That's because any overdue fines at the library will be waived in exchange for a picture of a pussycat. The response is being overwhelming.
You're kidding.
What? Okay. I don't understand any of that.
What, is there some sort of psychology behind this where they've realised some people might actually send the cat and also pay the fine?
No, I think this is purely because the people who run the library just like cats.
How bizarre.
Yeah, it's totally weird. The website handling memberships for Tasmania's future AFL team has run out of merchandise. The number of people paying the $10 to become a Tasmanian Devils member has now hit almost 100,000. Only Collingwood West Coast and Richmond have more members, although these numbers are meaningless because it's not apples with apples.
Like, no.
How do you compare an 11-game membership with a
membership that costs, like, you know, 10 upwards
bucks.
Of $1,000
yeah,
where you're in the running to go to the grand final at the end of the season versus, you know, a gold membership for an existing club or a $10 one for a thought bubble.
It's good fun, but it's not really scientific.
It's great marketing, though.
Terrific. Pensioners are waiting twice as long to receive their payments. Data from Services Australia shows some waited 152 days last year for their claims to be processed, 2 months more than the usual 84 days. Well, that's great if you're living payment to payment. Doctors are warning Australia's health system is not prepared for the growing impact of climate change. The Royal Australasian College of Physicians says more frequent heatwaves, bushfires and floods will increase the burden on hospitals. President Dr. Jacqueline Small says extra funding is needed to help the system deal with issues like heat stroke and smoke inhalation.
We're looking for a climate resilient health system that can withstand the changing climate and a sustainable health system that reduces the impact on climate change by the health system.
Don't want to go all Paul Murray at this early hour, but crikey, haven't got more immediate concerns and sort of David Suzuki inspired tosh about the planet melting.
No, it's a good way to get more funding, isn't it? It's very trendy, sort of.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's like anyone in business at the moment is talking about AI development. We're integrating AI into our systems. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. What does that mean?
Well, and also everyone's favourite environmental social governance.
Mm.
You know, what are you doing to save the planet?
Yes. Whilst,
you know,
very trendy.
Working in a bank, whatever it is.
12.7 degrees outside at the moment. That's the highlight. Top of 22 today. Very cool. We haven't had a day like this in it. Feels like forever. 22, just the top, partly cloudy sort of a day. Winds, nothing much to speak of, but reasonably pleasant, in fact. But then the next few days are magnificent. Sunny in 24 tomorrow, sunny in 24 Friday, sunny in 25 on Saturday, sunny in 25 on Sunday, Monday's 25, Tuesday 24, so it's moderated a little bit. It looked like it was progressing back towards 30 at the early part of next week, but still remaining in that mid-20 range with nothing else of note on the forecast. UV today sits at 8, which is considered very high. When the UV's 3 and above, cover up, use sun protection, stay sun smart, and download the Sun Smart app.
We're talking about big life decisions, you know, vis-a-vis tedious but necessary fix-up jobs around the house versus taking your family on a big holiday if you're in a position to do so. This in the context of, you know, taxpayers reserving the right to fund things also because they're entertaining, e.g. sports stadiums. Lindsay texted in on the Dutton's text line saying, "G'day boys, we need a new kitchen, a new bathroom, lots of pieces done around the house. But this December is part of our anniversary and my son's 21st birthday. We're all heading to Europe for a 3-week holiday. The memories created by this will far outweigh any kitchen or bathroom and any small jobs fixed up around the house. Well, we'll get to those later. Good on you, Lindsay, and have a great time.
Yeah, absolutely. Keep those texts coming in on the Dutton's text line. Big Ten Ford, GWM Havel, Hyundai, Isuzu Ute, Mazda, Mitsubishi, Nissan, Ram, Subaru and Volkswagen. Dutton's, they're easy to do business with. Tom Wren's in the 5AA Breakfast Studio with us as we pivot to sport. Agostino Mitsubishi's Good to Go giveaways on now. Receive a bonus $1,000 fuel card on the 2023 Build Outlander. Morning, Rennie.
Morning, Will. Morning, David. I'll get to Travis Boak in a minute. He's playing his 350th game. But first off, just want to talk about the Brisbane Olympics and what's going on there.
Oh, yeah.
What an
this is
absolute
a
debacle. I heard Liesl Jones this morning, a three-time gold medalist, one of our great swimmers, you know, one of our greatest breaststrokers of all time, or world for that matter. She's saying it could be the death of the Olympics. So at the moment, the whole thing's a schmozzle. The state government's in crisis control, denying reports that they tried to cancel the Olympics, and then it was $500 million in compensation they'd have to pay if they did that. So they're forging ahead, but the stadium they're going to put on, which is, you know, it should be your centrepiece, the athletic stadium. Mm. It should be, this is, you know, a rolled gold stadium. It's going to be the smallest since Amsterdam in 1928, half the size of Paris, which just held the Olympics. It is costing way more than they thought, and it is just looking like, you know, a two-bit shantytown operation at the moment. It is just not good at all.
It's staggering, isn't it? And haven't they, so are they building a new stadium, or are they doing up the Gabba?
Well, they were doing up the Gabba.
No, they're building this is their new plan. They're building this new athletic stadium.
The athletic stadium.
It's a 40,000 seater.
Yeah.
Right. 40,000. 40,000, that's not very big.
The Premier's ignoring a report and instead going with this athletic stadium.
He's halfwit, that bloke. He's going to lose the election.
So far, it's not even funny.
Yeah. He's a complete drongo.
The headline on the Courier Mail this morning is "Party like it's 1928."
That is a great headline. Oh, that's an excellent headline.
I mean, just watch this space. But you know, they can be, and I've heard some commentary on this. They can be events that define your city, like Sydney. Brilliant, amazing.
Sydney was good because Sydney, like, all the infrastructure was new, and it was in a part of Sydney. You think about, like, West Lakes in South Australia in the 1970s. Like, it was this sort of swampy, boggy, you know, byway of the Parramatta River that had, like, light industry out there. But there was plenty of room to move, and now it's become a residential area.
Yeah.
Like, it was actually really good for the city.
It was really good. Atlanta, though, it can be really bad. That was
Atlanta
poor.
Was shocking.
Terrible. Rio, terrible. You know, not a great experience. And it can be a lasting legacy. Now, they're big cities, but for Brisbane, it could be a really bad lasting effect, and I think more broadly for Australia. So
just people's appetites seem to have changed. The Commonwealth Games discussion, and this is happening with Olympics and FIFA World Cups as well, it seems to be a good sell to people to say, do we need to spend all this money on a two-week sporting event? And it seems to defy culture. It doesn't seem to matter whether it's in the Western world or it's the Middle East is different because it's sovereign wealth and money doesn't even matter. But right around the world at the moment, whenever these big events come up, it seems to be something that attracts a lot of support if you say, is this a good priority? Is this a good way to spend money?
Let's put it into health.
That's right. Well, that's why these things are, there's question marks about maybe the Olympics should always be in the same place.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think part of the problem too, that, and this is where Sydney was so good. Sydney had this, like, you know, we've got the blue coats, the people who do all the voluntary work at the Adelaide Oval, and they're always down there helping out, you know. Sydney had this absolute army of volunteers, and it was also really easy to get cheap tickets. So you had the real high-end stuff like the swimming that you needed money and luck to get tickets to that. But you could go and watch, like, the weightlifting.
Yeah, or the volleyball.
Tickets, yeah, I think on. The cheapest tickets from memory were $19.
That's great.
It was just brilliant, you know. And all of the infrastructure, there were so many public spaces as well. The problem with it is sport becomes out of the market for people without big incomes.
Yeah.
And that's what's happened with the Olympics and the World Cups.
And I reckon Sydney's part of the reason we have this discussion. Sydney was, what, 24 years ago, but it's real recent enough in the memory. Whereas Melbourne in 56 compared to 2000 was a generation removed.
Yeah.
And I think when Sydney got it felt really special. It was like, oh, the Olympics are coming to Australia.
Yeah.
Spare no expense. Brisbane to Sydney, albeit it'll be 32 years once you get there, but the build-up's shorter than that, kind of feels like, It feels less special.
Yeah,
it just feels less special. No, and I reckon it's harder to sell a $1 billion stadium this time round.
Yep, it's a fair call. Valid points. We will get to Boakey for Port fans. We'll do him
350th.
Tomorrow. He's talking today, so we'll run a bit of that tomorrow.
Fantastic. Looking forward to it.
Pity it's an away game.
Yeah.
Would it be nice for him down the road with the fans? Yeah. Anyway.
Good on you, Reddy.
Thanks, boys.
Thanks, Tom.
This is 5AA News. Always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy in 22 today with the 6:30 news. I'm Graham Goodings.
Injured or living with chronic pain? Book an appointment at Physio Extra today. 6 locations. PhysioExtra.com.
Caught today for 3 teenagers arrested and charged over a crime spree in the east and northeastern suburbs. 6 vehicles were allegedly stolen across 5 days. A Mitsubishi Eclipse, Volkswagen Jetta, Kia Cerato and Land Rover Discovery from properties in Lightsview, Paraka and St George's, and a Porsche and a Mercedes from Leebrook yesterday. Only the latter two have been recovered. Boys aged 13, 15 and 16 have been charged with illegal use of a motor vehicle. The two older boys have also been charged with attempted aggravated serious criminal trespass. Charlie Stevens has been given 2 lasting legacies by family members. Mel Usher has the story.
Police Commissioner Grant Stevens' teenage son, killed in an alleged hit run during schoolies last year, has been honoured by his sister. Sophie recently gave birth to a daughter, and Charlie is the newborn's second name. Days earlier, another family member welcomed a boy, and Charles was also chosen as the second name. Commissioner Stevens says it means so much to have Charlie's name live on.
Startling figures from the RAA today. Motorists have shelled out more than $400 million in fines for more than 1 million speeding offences committed on South Australian roads in the past 5 years. 202,358 speeding fines were issued last year, 3,548 more than the preceding year, and the highest number since 2020. The huge number of fines has prompted RAA to remind drivers that speeding is one of the fatal 5 causes of road trauma. Doctors say major reforms are needed to help Australia's healthcare system deal with the growing impact of climate change. The Royal Australasian College of Physicians says more funding is needed to help doctors and hospitals treat people affected by heatwaves and bushfires. President Dr. Jacqueline Small says we need to be more prepared to deal with extreme weather events.
There's a range of health impacts that can occur during these extreme events, from the direct effects of heat stroke, for example, and that's becoming an increasing issue. But there may also be other impacts such as inhalation of smoke from bushfires.
Pensioners are waiting twice as long to receive their payments. Data from Services Australia shows some waited 152 days last year for their claims to be processed, 2 months more than the usual 84 days. Former US President Donald Trump is doubling down on his threat to kick Prince Harry out of America. The Duke of Sussex is facing potential deportation if it emerges he lied about his drug use on his visa application. Mr. Trump warns he faces an uncertain future in the country if he wins the upcoming election.
Should he get special privileges that nobody else does?
No, and we'll have to see. If they know something about the drugs and if he lied, they'll have to take appropriate action.
Appropriate action?
Yeah.
Which might mean not staying in America.
Oh, I don't know. You'll have to tell me. You just have to tell me.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Agostino Mitsubishi's Good To Go giveaway is on now. Receive a bonus $2,000 fuel card on 2023 build Triton.
And here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start with footy. Adelaide forward Taylor Walker has taken a big step towards playing in Friday night's clash against Geelong at home after getting through last night's training session. The 33-year-old looked good during the session and the club will now wait to see how he pulls up today. Well, Hawthorn has been given a boost ahead of Saturday's clash against Melbourne. That's after captain James Sicily successfully downgraded his one-match suspension from kicking down to a fine. That was at the tribunal last evening. Meantime, Essendon coach Brad Scott insists he's trying to win every game, but admits it'll take time for the Bombers to be a consistent team. He's told by World of Sports, Bombers fans know it will take time.
I think it's ridiculous to ask Essendon people, you know, who have been starved of final success over the last 20 years to be patient. I just think it's understanding that these things take time. It's not, it's, you know, I wish I could click my fingers and get it done. And that's not to say that you know, we're setting up, you know, to win every single game we play.
Let's go to some soccer now, and Essendon is determined to be a leader for the Socceroos in tomorrow night's World Cup qualifier against Lebanon. The national side is undergoing a transition period with several key players retiring in recent years. Irvine says he wants to help lift his teammates on the way to the 2026 tournament in America.
I like to think of myself as a player that can try and help get the best out of my teammates. You know, that's one of my qualities I think that coaches have obviously identified in me.
And that is the 5AA Sport.
And now the 5AA Forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video. Direct to you from your AutoMasters technician.
Partly cloudy in 22 today. Tomorrow, sunny 24. Friday, sunny 24. Saturday, sunny 25. Currently, it's just 12. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
24 minutes to 7. You can jump into the program and have your say at any time, of course, with the Dunton's text line. Big 10 Ford, GWM Havel, Hyundai, Isuzu, Ute, Mazda, Mitsubishi, Nissan, Ram, Subaru and Volkswagen. Dunton's, easy to do business with this morning. Power Pack lineup. Sean Fuster will join us. We're around the courts. David Kosh on the new Tassie team and indeed the RBA's curious decision yesterday. Kosh, you'll unpack it. Josh Rochelli from the Adelaide Football Club after 8 o'clock and the Police Commissioner Grant Stevens. This is a development out of the United States. Nigel Farage, who was the head of was a member of UKIP, the UK Independence Party. He was the head of the Brexit Party for a while. British politician, essentially, on the right of British politics, who championed Brexit.
The man who turned the word expert into an insult.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm. He was sick of hearing from the experts.
He's not a... he's not a politician any longer. He's a broadcaster. He works for GB News. I think we might have played the odd grab of shows he's done, bits and pieces. He's had a sit-down interview with Donald Trump, and he's been asked on behalf of Sky News here in Australia to ask him a question about Australia and one very specific Australian. Here is Nigel Farage with Donald Trump.
Our friends at Sky News Australia wanted me to ask you this. The AUKUS deal that's in place on nuclear submarines, America... You know, the UK, Australia, very, very important deal. It's there to try and combat that huge growth, naval growth in China. But now, of course, things have changed in Australia. We've got a Labour government in Australia. The previous ambassador, Joe Hockey, I think was quite a good friend of yours. You got on pretty well with him. Now they've appointed Kevin Rudd, former Labour MP. I mean, he has said the most horrible things. You were a destructive president, a traitor to the West, and he's now Australia's ambassador in Washington.
Yeah, well, I don't know.
Would you take a phone call from him?
He won't be there long if that's the case. I don't know much about him. I heard he was a little bit nasty. I hear he's not the brightest bulb, but I don't know much about him. But if he's at all hostile, he will not be there long.
Did Nigel Farage just sink the AUKUS deal, do you think?
Oh, jeez. Well, it's funny, isn't it? Because, I mean, quite a few people on the Labor side have got a rich back catalogue of vituperative anti-Trump rhetoric, and now that with the prospect of him becoming president again, they're like, oh, well, you know, it's a democracy in action, and we can work with anyone.
Can Rudd be the ambassador to our most important ally?
Not the brightest bulb.
If he's been canning, and I drop a word there, but he's been canning the guy who's most likely to be the next president of the United States. It's not a tenable situation, surely.
It reminds me a bit of when Bob Carr became foreign minister, when he went into federal politics after he'd been in state politics, and he was doing a blog just for his own entertainment, and the blog became this excellent and no-holds-barred running critique of how increasingly useless the Gillard government had become. Well, suddenly, Bob found himself in the position where he got the call up to fill a Senate vacancy.
That's right.
And then he became Julia Gillard's foreign minister. With typical Bob Carr bombast, he held this press conference when all this became confirmed. And at the start he said, "No, I just want to say one thing. I've recently been writing a blog. Don't read anything in it. It will only confuse you." And it was just like total chutzpah because he was trying to say, look, you know, there's 100 stories in that blog. I'm not going to engage on any of them. Those opinions are no longer operative. I think, though, what an impertinence Trump's got to basically say he's not going to be there long. Like, he's got some power as to who Australia appoints as its ambassador to Washington.
But I think that might show a degree of insight. Like, we're relying on these guys to underpin our whole security plan for the next 40 years. It might be good to have someone over there dealing with them who doesn't suggest that the leader of that country is a threat to democracy.
I'm sure if you went back through Rudd's tweet, and, you know, let's not forget, Trump became such a political force in large part because of use of social media.
Yes.
Like, there'd be a rich load. I wonder if Trump, it'd be worth checking. Some enterprising journo with a spare few hours this afternoon should sit down and see how many of Rudd's tweets has he deleted.
Mm.
Or are they all still there? Either way, it's a story.
Mm, completely.
Because it'd be you could do a double-page spread on the stuff that he said
about
Kevin, Trump.
You know Kevin Rudd better than most. Does he? I don't even know what the protocol is with regard to an ambassador, but he feels like he needs to respond to this, doesn't he? Doesn't he need to say something?
But I don't think he can.
He's not allowed to?
Well, so last Friday at the Tysers Bigger Better South Australia lunch, I did the interview on stage with Mally and Albo, and it was the splash on Saturday. The second question I asked Albo was, can the AUKUS deal survive a second Trump presidency? And Albo's answer was, look, the deal is bigger than any one individual. And then he said, anyone who knows Kevin Rudd will know how hard he has been working. He specifically named Kevin Rudd as being the thing that was going to save the AUKUS deal. And he said that Rudd's advice to him was, there's a recognition in Washington that the deal is too big to fail and it transcends personality politics or whatever. Well, I don't know if that's true, because one of the things that's defined Trump is his sense of retribution. You know, when you look at so many of the people that he's fallen out with, he and people on the Republican side, be it like, you know, Pence or Mitch McConnell, he's got no compunction about not just writing people off, but publicly stating that he wants them, you know, crucified, and saying that they've got no character, that they're crooks, or that they're mentally unwell. Like, he's just shameless when it comes to saying, I hate this person, they wronged me, and I want them
destroyed.
They're
dead to me, yeah. It was put to me by people that know the finer details of the AUKUS deal in the US, that the whole thing is White House proof, which is to say it can't be nixed by a president who just wants, like, a power of veto like they have over legislation there. It would require a majority. It would require a hostile president and a majority in both the Senate and indeed the House of Reps there, which almost never happens. Mm. And they have elections every 2 years. So the idea is it would be very hard for it to change, no matter how much Trump hated the whole thing. So,
well, maybe that's wishful thinking.
It might be. But that's for people that are a party to the whole deal, say that's what they draw their confidence from. That it's the way it's legislated is really hard to undo.
Yeah.
But
the thing is,
I don't think it helps having a bloke over there saying Trump is the end, is, you know, the end is nigh with a Trump presidency as our representative, our best man on the job over there representing Australians.
The truth too, personality-wise, Trump and Rudd are quite similar because they are both full-blown narcissists. So they're not actually that different. So Trump's petulance, it's actually kind of mirrored by Rudd's. Mm. Like Rudd's, you should hear him talk about, well, the way he used to talk about Julia Gillard, he used to habitually in phone calls call her that effing bitch.
Mm.
You know, like every journo who spoke to him about all this stuff knows that for a fact. And there was this clubby little off-the-record convention that said, well, if that's the way the former Prime Minister chooses to speak about Australia's first female Prime Minister, let's not go there. Well, you know, his contempt for the people who pulled him down, it burns to this day. You know, it's extraordinary. So, you know, I think that they're actually much more alike than they'd care to think.
Spending a bit of time with this because it is breaking news out of the United States. You don't often get Donald Trump talking about Australia and Australians in such specific detail. The deputy leader of the opposition here in Australia, Susan Lowe, has just been asked about this development on Sky News.
Going to follow my usual practice, which is not to comment on US domestic politics, but I do want to say this. Kevin Rudd is our ambassador, so we want him to do well because he represents Australia's national interest in the US. I think members of the Albanese government might reflect, however, that commenting on another country's domestic political situation is not a good idea. Claire O'Neill, the Home Affairs Minister, also made commentary about the US and certain personnel, and it's just not very smart.
Yeah, I wonder who she could be talking about.
Yeah, certain personnel.
You're going to be hearing a lot about that story, I suspect, over the course of the day. We're going to check traffic and come back with police and weather in just a moment. Keyser, if you're tired of back pain, try Keyser, KIESER.com.au.
Thanks, Will. Good morning, David. Roads are looking pretty good today. Shouldn't have too many hassles. Do have a burst water main to look out for. Hope Valley, Reservoir Road near Berry Road. Got speeds at 40, but no real dramas. Brooklyn Park, bit of work there. Sedona Barber Drive near Marin Road. And it is slow at Old Nalunga for works too. Victor Harbour Road near Main South Road. Speeds at 40. You find cameras Chief Street, Brompton, and Military Road at Grange. 40 Weeks are celebrating 40 years with 50% off mattresses and 30% off bedroom furniture. Hurry, ends Sunday. Exclusions and T's and C's apply. Go to better sleep at 40 Weeks. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Jarvis Toyota has moved to their brand new home in Brighton Road, Somerton Park. Take advantage of opening savings across the Toyota Certified Pre-Owned range and enjoy the same feeling you get with a new Toyota at Jarvis Toyota. All certified pre-owned vehicles are tested and backed by Toyota, including a full service history and 90-point safety check. Toyota Certified, pre-owned in a class of its own. Jarvis Toyota, now at Brighton Road, Somerton Park, proudly celebrating 22 years of great deals.
Still thinking about a sea change? Think Oakford Homes in Counter Bay. New stage released and selling fast. A variety of block sizes available in a friendly community with brand new low maintenance homes plus the beach close by. Affordable packages, no surprises, move in now or invest for the future. Fixed price turnkey packages, flat land ready to build. Don't miss out. New stage now released. Visit our display village at Encounter Bay. Oakford Homes, a statement of quality. oakfordhomes.com.au.
Get saving this month at City Discount Tyres. Grab three Falcon Zeke ZE310R passenger car tyres and get the fourth tyre absolutely free. Experience top-notch performance with exceptional grip on both wet and dry surfaces. Steer your way to citydiscounttyres.com.au for even more great deals. City Discount Tyres. We're driven by value.
If you have an electric hot water service at home or instant gas to heat your water, I'm sorry to say, you're losing money every day. With an EcoVantage heat pump hot water system, you could save up to a whopping 50% on your water heating costs. And if you're a concession card holder, make the switch to an EcoVantage heat pump hot water system. The upfront costs are even lower. EcoVantage, the savings are real. Visit ecovantage.com.au.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
12 minutes to 7. A couple of good texts coming through at the moment.
Hey, a big shout out to Chris in Nova Gardens. This is excellent. Remember a couple of weeks ago, apropos of nothing, and this does happen more often than not, my meandering brain drifted off with a on-air love letter to the 1970s prawn cocktail. Well, Chris, not only did he get inspired by that little chat, he went and made the classic 1970s prawn cocktails, followed by King George Whiting, washed down with a large G&T, but he's gone to the trouble of sending us photographs. I've got to say, Chris, mate, you galloping gourmet, I reckon you nailed it. They look absolutely superb.
That was terrific work. Our resident stats man, Ben Jordan's contact with the program. You said an enterprising journalist needs today, given the Rudd-Trump discussion that's just happened in the United States, with Trump saying, well, if he, you know, he holds those opinions towards me, he's not going to be the ambassador for very long. You wondered, well, does he have still tweets up critical of Donald Trump? Has he deleted them? I can tell you the answer to the second is no, he hasn't deleted them. Here's a Trump tweet, a Kevin Rudd tweet from the office of Kevin Rudd. It's signed 2nd of June 2020. the most destructive president. It's got a picture of Donald Trump holding up the Bible. The most destructive president in history. He drags America and democracy through the mud. He thrives on fomenting, not healing, division. He abuses Christianity, church and Bible to justify violence, all aided and abetted by Murdoch's Fox News network in America, which feeds this. That is our man advocating on our behalf, potentially, to US President Donald Trump at the end of this year.
Now trying to pass himself off as just a loyal civil servant providing, you know, neutral and impartial consular aid to our country as it prosecutes the AUKUS deal.
That story's going to blow up over the course of the day. Thank you, Ben. That, he took 3 seconds to find that tweet, which makes me think there might be some more out there. Jenny Horvat from the Weather Bureau's on the line. Jenny, a much milder day today.
Yeah, that's right. Things are a little bit more stable. We've had that cold front move through and it's just dropped those temperatures down a little bit. So we've got that southerly airstream at the moment. We'll tend a little bit more southeasterly as we head into the later part of the day, and we could see a little bit gusty around the foothills there with the gully winds later today. But we are looking at top temperature of 22 degrees for the city and northern suburbs, 21 along the coast, 18 degrees for Mount Barker. Currently 12.1 at the West Terrace Night Appear observation site, and that is about our minimum. Wasn't much cooler not that long ago. Things remaining pretty stable as we head into the rest of the week. High pressure system moving into south of the Bight, maintaining a ridge of high pressure, and those temperatures are hovering up in a sort of the mid-20s there. A little bit of sunshine around for Thursday and Friday. Not dissimilar as we head into the weekend there. Again, temperatures around 25 degrees with some sunny conditions, and it looks like that's going to see us into early next week as well there, guys. So a bit of a dry spell coming up, temperatures hovering in the mid-20s.
Lovely. Good stuff, Jenny. Thank you.
All right, let's head to Safe Pole. Senior Constable Rebecca Stokes is on the line. Rebecca, youths have been caught after a snatch-and-grab phone theft at Mawson Lakes.
Yes, this happened last night. About 9:20 p.m., a man was walking along Sanctuary Drive at Mawson Lakes when a group of youths snatched his phone from his hand. He chased after them and tried to get his phone back but was assaulted. He was assisted by members of the public who drove him around the area to look for the offenders and helped him to contact police. The suspects were spotted heading towards the interchange, and police were quickly on scene and located three male suspects on Elder Smith Road. The teenagers were 13, 14 and 15. They were all arrested and charged with theft and assault and will appear in the youth court at a later date. So good work there by the public and police to grab that group.
I tell you, that's the second time we've heard about 13-year-olds running around breaking the law this morning, Rebecca. It's unbelievable. Also, a bloke's been caught acting suspiciously at Glenelg North.
Yeah, about 2:15 this morning, police were called to Adelphi Terrace at Glenelg North after a vigilant member of the public spotted a man acting suspiciously around cars, including shining a torch inside the vehicles. Our Southern and Western patrols attended the area and located the man in a nearby car park. And it will be alleged that in his possession we found a small amount of methamphetamine and two ice pipes. And police checks revealed he was also wanted for a number of outstanding matters. He's a 21-year-old Manipara man. He's been arrested and charged with illegal interference with vehicles, possessing controlled drugs and possessing drug equipment. So he's been interviewed in relation to the outstanding matters. He's expected to be refused bail and he'll appear in court later today.
Good stuff, Rebecca. Thank you for that. Rebecca Stokes there from SAPOL. Text from Con. Gentle reminder, Socceroos v Lebanon this Thursday, March 21 in a World Cup qualifier. Or if people prefer, there's two Melbourne suburbs playing an AFL match the same night. Good on you, Con. Couldn't agree with you more.
Good stuff. Looking forward to that.
That's how they should get the Tassie side into the comp. Just get rid of one of those Victorian sides that nobody barracks for.
That would help.
I can think of about three. See the crowd at Melbourne Footscray last week? My God.
Was it bad?
It's pathetic. It's terrible.
Was it?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, let's head out on the road, catch up with Jade Robin, who's cruising Adelaide streets in her Volkswagen Tiguan Allspace, searching for breaking news, thanks to Dutton's Volkswagen. Morning to you, Jade.
Good morning, guys. Good morning, listeners. Now, it is good news for some yesterday with the RBA keeping rates on hold, as we heard, but it may just keep this restaurant open where I am on McGill Road for a little while yet. Rusco and Brusco, they opened just 18 months ago. It's a beautiful Italian little restaurant here in St. Maurice. Now, the owner has come out to say he's just weeks away from closing his doors because he simply just cannot afford to stay open, blaming skyrocketing prices for absolutely everything going up. And that's the problem here. It's not just one or two items. These smaller businesses are having to fork out more for everything. He's also experienced a massive downturn in business. Now, not as many bums on seats, and that's sad because it is us. It's the public that keep these places ticking over. You know, when the government raise all these costs, costs of living go up, it's us. You know, it's the public that keep these small businesses alive. But of course, the public in this credit crunch is also, you know, cost of living crunches. We're also hurting as well. So sadly, Rusco Brusco, they're not the only ones. We've been talking about this quite a lot, and I've been visiting lots of cafes and restaurants around town. We've got Enzo's on in Hindmarsh there. They close on Saturday, May 4th. The Big Shed Brewing in Royal Park, as we know, they're threatening to close their doors as well because of cost of living. Wholesome in Googer Street, and already closed this year, is Lost in the Forest in Uraidla. Edcastle Pub in the CBD. Folklore, Port Adelaide, Cardone's down in Glenelg, the Little Banksia Tree in Bowden, Hammer and Tongs in Strathalbyn, and also My Lover Cindy. I mean, we're only in March. That's a lot of closures for small businesses. Mm. But you just wait until June, July, when all these businesses who opted into that basically zero interest rate loans, they end soon. So what then? Mm. So the Reserve Bank can't pretend they're all being, you know, nice and being our friends now. This is their mess. I know you guys are talking to Koshy at 7:50, so I'll be really interested to see what he has to say about all of this.
Yeah, absolutely, Jade. I think, too, the other thing is just how utterly exhausting running a small business is.
Mm.
You know, I saw Goodies and Grains, that fantastic Whole Food store in the arcade on the western side of the Central Market. They've announced they're shutting up shop. It's been there for 20-odd years, that place. It's really good for baking, like if you want to get flour and so forth. 33 years it's been there. Thank you, boys. 33 years, so three decades, and the owners just put up a thing on Facebook last week saying, sorry, guys, we're out.
But this is what the burden of dealing with inflation being carried by the few who have loans looks like.
Yeah, completely.
This is what it looks like. Now, we don't criticise, that's not a criticism of the Reserve Bank, they're just doing what they do, right? That's their job. They've only got one level. We've talked about this ad nauseum over the course of the last 18 months. If a government doesn't do things like spend less or tax more and spread the burden around, the only people that do it are those with loans. And people who have loans are those that have bought a house and have a mortgage, or people are in business, small businesses that have bought a premises or invested in things and they've had to borrow to do so.
Two categories of people are both working really hard.
Exactly right. Well, we're trying to. They're struggling in the case of a lot of the... That list that Jade just read out was really depressing. Jade, on McGill Road there, you got a traffic report for us? No, I think we've just lost Jade. She's just dropped off the line. There, we've just lost her. We might have a couple of texts on the Dutton's text line before we get to 5AA News.
One here saying about the Olympics. Morning, boys. The only way the Olympics... Sorry, it's just disappeared. No, there it is. The only way the Olympics can continue is either give them to a country and not just a city, or let them be held in Greece every 4 years and all the IOC members pay to keep the stadiums up to date. Cheers from Jimbo. Not my son, unless he's up uncharacteristically early. One here, do you honestly think the current government is gung-ho about the AUKUS deal? Our own Senator Don Farrell said something pretty inflammatory about the US only yesterday. Did he? Oh, no, he said he was asked about our closest partner, our closest ally.
And he said it's New Zealand.
And somebody said, oh, well, some might disagree that it's the US. Mm. You know, some might say it's New Zealand. Is that inflammatory?
Yeah.
It's probably just an unnecessary observation.
Yeah, that's a good category of thing, unnecessary observation.
And one here, apropos of nothing, Shane just texts in saying, admittedly, this is left of field, but I hear that Jeff Lynne's ELO tour of the US is their final tour. Wish I was there.
Well, there you go. Good stuff.
I like random thoughts.
Exactly right.
Good on you, Shane.
Few people have pointed out the Melbourne Bulldogs crowd actually was 44,100 as well.
Oh, really? Okay.
It's probably bigger than the Adelaide Oval.
I was probably
crowd.
A bit wrong about that. Yeah, but it didn't look that big. The MCG. I mean, I was comparing it to the Taylor Swift concert.
5AA.
No, just his pathological hatred of all those old clapped out Melbourne sides that nobody barracks for.
5AA News is coming up. We'll take you through a wrap of the morning stories next.
For over three decades, Regent Homes has been synonymous with crafting architecturally bespoke homes, each one a testament to Regent Homes' unwavering commitment to design, quality and sophistication. And because Regent Homes is a South Australian family-owned company, they understand more than anyone what it takes to build a family home. Experience Regent Homes' award-winning display homes at Lightsview and Blackwood Park.
innovative design, elevated living. Visit regenthomes.com.au.
You deserve your life-changing moment. You deserve life-changing care.
You've only got 7 days to buy your tickets in the Hospital Research Foundation Home Lottery. You could win the fully furnished $3.6 million Scott Salisbury Grand Prize at Henley Beach. Plus, your tickets stay in more than 12,000 draws, giving you a 1 in 15 chance to win. Hurry! Deadline March 27. Life-changing prizes, life-changing impact. HomeLottery.com.au.
License M14493.
Steinborner Automotive has always been well worth the trip. And now there's Barossa Mazda, Murray Street, Nuriapa. SA's newest Mazda dealership is now open. For 40 years, Steinborner has provided South Australians with outstanding customer service, exceptional value, and a large selection of new, used, and demo vehicles. The Steinborner story continues with the opening of their new state-of-the-art Mazda dealership in Barossa Valley. Barossa Mazda. It's well worth the trip. BarossaMazda.com.au.
Here at 5AA, we're all about supporting local. Purchase high fresh salads with the Little Heroes Foundation logo and part proceeds support children living with dementia. Find them at your local Drakes and Romeos. 5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube.
Local news and information first. This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy at 22 today. With the 7 o'clock news, good morning. I'm Graham Goodings.
Physio, Pilates, hydro, massage, podiatry and exercise classes. Physio Extra's holistic care. PhysioExtra.com.
Three boys, the youngest just 13, will front court today over a crime wave involving half a dozen cars. Mel Usher reports.
It's been revealed a Porsche and Mercedes stolen from Leabrook yesterday and later found dumped at Gillis Plains were part of a crime series. They've been linked to four other cars taken from various addresses since last Friday. A Mitsubishi Eclipse, Volkswagen Jetta, Kia Cerato and Land Rover Discovery were stolen from properties in Lightsview, Paraka and St George's. Those four cars are yet to be recovered. Three boys, a 13-year-old from Dafferin Park, 15-year-old from Holden Hill and 16-year-old from Flinders Park, have been charged with illegal use of a motor vehicle, the two older boys further charged with attempted aggravated serious criminal trespass. They'll appear in the youth court today.
The World Meteorological Organization says global heat records were smashed in 2023. In its annual State of the Climate report, the UN agency said temperatures were now getting dangerously close to the 1.5 degree limit agreed to at the climate summit in Paris. Head of the WMO, Celeste Salo, says 2023 was the warmest year on record.
It is imperative that our actions today are based on the welfare of future generations rather than short-term economic interests. I am now sounding the red alert about the state of the climate.
Meantime, it's been revealed Australia's missing out on major events, concerts and international conferences because it's too far to come and the subsequent impact on the environment. The Tourism and Transport Forum says there are serious concerns about the climate implications of the long-haul travel to get here. It says it highlights the need for Australia to build its own sustainable aviation fuel sector. And Australia's ongoing climate policy will be on the agenda in Canberra today when a range of experts gather. The Climate Integrity Summit will bring together economists, academics, parliamentarians and traditional owners. Australia Institute Climate and Energy Director Polly Hemming says climate conversation is vital as we draw closer to a federal election.
Climate and integrity were key themes of the 2022 election and I think they've only become more important for the Australian community. The summit really is an opportunity to see how we're tracking.
The by-election battle for Dunstan has taken another turn. Labor candidate Cressida O'Hanlon has claimed she had nothing to do with her husband's business, Citadel Secure, despite being listed on the website as a senior associate. It follows questions about Liberal candidate Anna Finizio's links to a failed family business, Formway Group. Dunstan voters will go to the polls this Saturday. The federal government won't proceed with changes to religious freedom laws without bipartisan support. The reform would have seen religious schools no longer be able to hire teachers based on their faith. But Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has told caucus it won't go ahead without support from the coalition. And now turning to 5AA Sport.
Agostino Mitsubishi's Good To Go giveaway is on now. Receive a bonus $1,000 fuel card on 2023 build-out Lander.
And good morning, Tom Wren.
And a very good morning to you as well, Graham. We're going to start with football. Port Adelaide veteran Travis Boak admits 2023 was a difficult year, but he now feels he has greater clarity in both his role and his body. As he prepares for his 350th game against Richmond on Sunday at the MCG, the 35-year-old admitted to AFL 360 last season was tough.
It's probably nearly the most challenging year I've had in terms of injury-wise. I cracked my rib twice during the year and was just not able to get going. I went into a new role that I wasn't sort of familiar with. But towards the back end of the year, I felt like I still had a lot more to go. I started feeling healthier again.
Meantime, Hawthorn's James Sicily is free to play against Melbourne on Saturday after successfully downgrading his kicking charge to a fine. Well, the Miami Open preparation for tennis star Aryna Sabalenka has been thrown into disarray by the death of her partner. Craig Gabriel reports from Miami.
Former ice hockey player Konstantin Koltsov, who represented Belarus at two Olympic Games, has died. The 42-year-old was with Sabalenka when she won the Australian Open this year, and she acknowledged him. The tragic situation occurred here in Miami, where Sabalenka is the second seed. She has a first-round bye, and it's understood she's still intending to play the tournament. In 2019, her father died suddenly at the age of only 43. She paid tribute to him at the Australian Open.
This weekend, Aussie Formula One racer Daniel Ricciardo will have a 10th tilt at the Australian Grand Prix. He says he's excited to return to his home race and has his sights set on a top 10 finish. And the International Olympic Committee has ruled Russian and Belarusian athletes will not take part in the opening ceremony in Paris. And that's the 5AA sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
Lynn Andrews Real Estate, experts in commercial and residential property management. lynnandrews.com.au.
Morning there. Roads aren't looking too bad for the driving today. Do have Bruce Waterway to look out for at Hope Valley. Reservoir Road near Berry Road got speeds at 40, but it shouldn't give you any great delays. Activity at Brooklyn Park is slow, so Donald Rambert Drive near Marion Road, and we are getting busy at Old Noarlunga. Victor Harbour Road near Main South Road. Slow going Brighton Road, Brighton, with a camera this morning. Hawthorn Road at Mount Barker. It's a new Easter tradition, Hot Cross Muffins at Muffin Break. Pair it with a spiced iced mocha for the perfect Easter break. Hurry, limited time only at Muffin Break. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video, direct to you from your AutoMasters technician.
Partly cloudy and 22 today. Tomorrow, sunny 24. Friday, sunny 24. Saturday, sunny 25. Currently, cooler than it's been for some time, just 12 degrees. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Setting the agenda for South Australia.
This is 5AA, always Adelaide.
Ray White.
Around in the world of news. Lots ahead on the program too. Great lineup today. Sean Fuster's going to join us. We'll go around the courts after 7 o'clock. Also, David Koch on the RBA decision yesterday in the Tassie state election, which is a footy story because the election, one of the big issues, or perhaps the biggest issue, is about a stadium that is required for Tasmania to enter the competition in 2028, the AFL that is. So we'll talk to Koshy about that. Then after 8 o'clock, Josh Rochelli, his last quarter heroics, not enough to get the Crows over the line on Saturday night. What's the mood in the camp been this week? And the Police Commissioner, Grant Stevens, will join us to talk about the spate of crimes that necessitated a special operation in Rundle Mall this week that, what was it, 15 minutes in?
Yeah.
Had collared its first would-be shoplifter?
We announced it on air at 8:35, and when Matt Pantelis was doing the morning show, 1 hour later, we were provided with a photograph of a shoplifter being arrested outside Rebel Sport, the very spot where the 15-year-old girl still awaiting trial for knocking out a shop assistant.
Mm.
Extraordinary.
Well, we spoke a bit about this in the last half hour of the program. For those just joining us and waking up, South Australians whose economic future is largely predicated on the successful execution of the AUKUS deal, you'll be interested to hear what transpired when Donald Trump sat down for an interview with former British politician, now broadcaster for GB News, Nigel Farage. He asked Donald Trump about Australian ambassador to the US, Kevin Rudd, and some of his previous tweets that had been extraordinarily critical of the U.S. president, former U.S. president in Donald Trump. Here was the Trump's answer.
I don't know much about him. I heard he was a little bit nasty. I hear he's not the brightest bulb, but I don't know much about him. But if he's at all hostile, he will not be there long.
He will not be there long. The U.S. election, November this year, for those that are struggling to keep track.
Trump, unbackable odds to win as well.
Yeah. So that story is a developing one that's only come out in the last half an hour. You'll hear a lot more about that over the course of the day. Front page news on the Courier Mail in Queensland this morning has gone to town on Premier Stephen Miles. And well, they might, because all the polling suggests he's very much soon to be recent Premier.
He's about as popular as European carp, that bloke.
He really is. And right now, there is a mess up there with regard to the 2032 Brisbane Olympic Games. So much so, the state government has had to come out and emphatically deny that they sought advice to cancel the Olympic Games a la Victoria, which is to say, someone in Australia looked at what Dan Andrews did with the Commonwealth Games and went, that actually sounds like a pretty good idea.
Well, didn't that cost Dan Andrews $350 million, i.e. the taxpayers of Victoria, $350 million to do nothing?
Lots of reports last night that the Queensland government had considered cancelling the Games due to public backlash over the venue costs. Support there about how this whole thing had been managed by the government was waning, and so they looked at it. The cost reportedly somewhere in the order of $500 million, $500 million, if you just wanted to walk away from the whole thing. The Premier has said there that the state government is committed to the 2032 Olympics. But even that being the case, there's all sorts of stuff going on there at the moment. The front page of the Courier Mail this morning says, party like it's 1928. The British Olympic Stadium that the government has now settled on will be the smallest since 1928, when the Games were held at Amsterdam 104 years earlier. The stadium would be 40,000 seats in total. It would cost $1.6 billion to build. You have to go back so far. The other notable thing that happened in Amsterdam was it was the first time women participated. You know, that's how far back.
Seriously?
In the athletics component of
it. Was it that late that they were allowed to compete?
Yeah, in the athletics component of things. So let's have a listen to some of the key players, because it just feels like this whole thing's descending into an absolute shambles at the moment. The backdrop, of course, Queensland's just had a by-election. The government got smashed, and all indications are they're on the way out. Here is Stephen Miles, the Premier.
The Gabba is a complete redevelopment of the stadium. We assessed all of the redevelopment options for the Gabba, and it came out as the best value for money.
I could not commit $3.4 billion of Queenslanders' money to a new stadium.
That's on the decision with regard to the stadiums or the Gabba redevelopment, about which there's been reports saying you should do one thing and the government's decided to do the other. Here's the opposition leader, or the man we're now calling soon-to-be Premier of Queensland.
For 1,000 days, the government has just spoken about sporting stadiums, and we're no closer to where we should have been 3 years ago.
And this was a nice cheeky bit from the New South Wales Treasurer, Daniel Mookey.
Our record is unmatched, and we've set a very high standard for Queensland to reach, and if they can't do it, they should give me a call.
Which is good old-fashioned Australian state rivalry.
Are we missing a trick here? Because Sydney did it in 2000. We can't give it back to them just 24 years later.
Yeah, I like what you're saying.
Now, we've shown that for a bang-for-your-buck outlay of rumoured to be $60 to $80 million, we've got gather-round for 4 years, right? We put in a bit of dough to help the cash-strapped Saudis stage the LIV Golf Tournament at Grange. Yep. That was a roaring success.
Yeah. We do have the major events fund.
We have the major... I'm sure Leon Bignall's listening. Mm. And the Premier, who's shown he's not shy, he was walking around the middle of the Adelaide Oval last year with Gil McLachlan holding a chequebook in his back pocket. It was announced as a sort of curtain raiser to the actual game that we had the gather round for another 3 years. Mm. I can see... rowing down there, Military Road, Westlakes, your old neck of the woods, Will.
Ready to go. Beautiful spot.
Get the dressage, the equestrian happening up somewhere in the Adelaide Hills. Mm. We got a velodrome that's in tip-top shape. It's only about 50
World
years old.
World class.
Why isn't Adelaide part of the mix?
I think...
What events could be held where, folks? 8223-0000. Yeah,
we're ready to step up.
They could do some of the high jump, track work at Etzer Park. Mm. I'd like to see some suburban grounds getting involved, like Goody Saints.
What would you do there?
I don't know. They've got that new grandstand.
The breakdancing.
Yeah, maybe. Why not?
Why not? Well, if you can help us out, get your suggestions coming in, folks. 8223 000. Text us on the Dutton's text line.
Put Adelaide on the map.
Yeah, exactly right. Hey, we've got an announcement on the next James Bond. Here's Daniel Craig leaving the role.
You know, I've been doing this for a while, and there's some people I've actually worked with here, I think, most of my career, which is getting on for about 30 years, so that's quite a long time. And a lot of people here worked on 5 pictures with me, and I know there's a lot of things said about what I think about these films and all of those, whatever, but I've loved every single second of these movies, and especially this one, because I've got up every morning and I've had the chance to work with you guys. And that has been one of the greatest honours of my life.
I think Daniel Craig's done a pretty good job. I think he's been a solid Bond, more in the Sean Connery mould of the old hard man kind of Bond.
I must admit, I've not seen a single one of the modern Bonds. I've only seen some of them, Connery and Moore ones.
Some of them look absolutely spectacular. Daniel Craig, I think, has done a pretty good job. I confess, though, I'm not familiar with the man who reportedly today has been offered the role. Now, it's not officially announced because he hasn't accepted yet, but I think you're mad if you don't accept the offer to be made the next Bond. British actor.
You'd accept.
I would, 100%. Yeah. No disrespect, though. I don't think the offer's... I think they got lost in the mail. I don't think it's coming. But, yeah, you'd be mad not to accept it.
You scrub up pretty well on the news.
British actor Aaron Taylor-Johnson is the man who has been offered the job as the next Bond. Have a listen. This is Aaron Taylor-Johnson.
Well, I just wanted to pack on the pounds, so I got really into eating In-N-Out Burger, and I kind of got... I almost got into...
Oh, that's fantastic.
Well, I knew there was this new way of this menu that you don't see, the secret menu, right? Which is a new whole world to me. It all opened up, the 4x4, the animal style, all this kind of thing.
Yeah.
So I'd have about 2 4x4s by 11 a.m. I'd have that as brunch.
So that's him talking on Stephen Colbert promoting a film a number of years ago. We just wanted to get you a sense of what his voice is like, because I have no history with Aaron Taylor-Johnson. Lucy was saying she was a fan of a film he made about 15 years ago. 15 years, notable being that's as long as Daniel Craig was James Bond. First played by Sean Connery in 1962 in Dr. No. Hard role to cast, because James Bond's is the one franchise I think everyone feels like they've got some degree of ownership over, almost intergenerationally, and have a sense of who the next Bond should be. But I don't know, can our listeners come up with a better... someone who's around at the moment who fits the profile that would be a good Bond? I think it's actually a really difficult question.
I wonder if the James Bond concept can survive the modern era, though. You know, this sort of martini guzzling womanizer.
Oh, he's softened a bit on that front. If you look at the early Sean Connery ones.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, some of the stuff, there's no chance in hell that it'd be written or filmed today.
Some of it's a bit close to sort of FNA Benny Hill humour too, like the sort of sexual sort of...
Yeah, the innuendo. Yeah. I mean, it has developed with the time.
Yeah.
But that is an interesting development on that front. If you've got a suggestion for us, we'd love to read it, because I'm stumped as to come up with the one, and I don't even know this Aaron Taylor-Johnson bloke is. Maybe you've got a history with him and you can tell us. 8223 000, text us on the Dutton's text line. Also, Easter now is just around the corner. Hague's is ramping up ahead of Easter, and despite the popularity, cost of living, of course, is front of mind. Have a listen to Alistair Haig, who was on 10 News First last night.
For Easter this year, we had to put on an extra 100 people just to cope with the extra production facilities and demands. Our team's already working on Easter next year, if not the year after. The costs have gone up over the last year. Cocoa's gone through the roof at the moment.
So cocoa's gone up. So, like, I mean, it doesn't feel like news these days to suggest something has increased in price. It's news if something hasn't increased in price. But a $100 milk chocolate egg at Haig's is about $11.90. A 100-gram Cadbury milk chocolate egg at Woolies or Coles is about $5 this year. And an 85-gram Lindt egg at Romeo's Foodland is worth about $11. But Easter, like pretty much everything else, is going to be more expensive this year.
We're getting an absolute mountain of text on the Dutton text line, people's ideas for the Adelaide Olympics. Daryl in Aldrinella says we'd be able to hold the dressage at Jepp's Cross at the new SAPOL barracks. Mark in Greenwood says we've got to reinstate the diving board at Burnside Pool and hold the high diving there. One here, from Amy saying, well, for starters, they're going to need to replace the water bubblers at Netball SA Stadium. I pay $42 every week to enter the stadium for my girls for netball. The bubblers are the same as when I played there 20 years ago. George says they could play soccer at Kilburn. No, that's right. It's still not finished.
No, you've got to play to the Comets' new stadium.
Well, they might need a slightly bigger fence, though.
Yeah. Well,
I'm sure the Adelaide City Council have come to the party.
They love sport. They love events.
They do. They love the V8s.
Yeah, they do.
They're really excited about the RV park as well for the V8s.
That needs to happen.
Yeah.
People need to enjoy the parklands.
100%. People in RVs need to enjoy the parklands.
Exactly right. Sue in Mylaw, who do you like for the new Bond?
A whole lot of us ladies get together and we talk about it every week. And
really?
Every week? Oh, yes. Absolutely. Very important.
Yeah, fair enough.
We definitely want Idris Elba.
Oh, now he was rumoured for a while.
He doesn't want it.
Yeah.
That's the problem.
He would be great.
He would be the hottest Bond ever. absolutely.
He's a terrific actor,
yes, too, Idris Elba. Him in a suit and, oh, gosh. Because I love Daniel, but it has very important who replaces him.
Yeah, we've got to... One of your friends might have just texted in, Sue, because Jess from Virginia says Idris Elba from the new Bond would be amazing.
Oh, gosh, yes. But
hey, Sue, do you and your female mates, do you ever discuss whether there should be a female Bond? Because some people have said...
We definitely do.
What do you reckon?
And definitely not.
Hmm.
Absolutely not. We do not want a lady Bond. I think, you know, it's a matter of world interest, and this is very important. We don't want a lady Bond, and if Idris can't do it, then, oh, crap, I don't know who I can think of. but the op shop I run in Milo, we have a thinking woman crumpets wall, and we have some lovely, adorable photos of really hot guys on the wall, and everybody suggests who we put up there, and Idris is... suggested quite often. I just have to find a decent photo to put up there. But, yes, it's our crumpet wall and it's
sure
very popular.
That'll be a labour of love for you, Sue. You can Google Idris Elba. Yeah, good on you. Thank you, Sue.
Jess in Virginia's with Sue. She's texted in saying Idris Elba for the new Bond would be amazing.
Yep, absolutely. Trav in Manapara has suggested, James Bond has to surely be Stephen Rowe. Caroline Wilson has to be the villain.
Oh, yeah.
That'd be an interesting film. Different fitting suit.
Mr. Rowe, you're all wet. Yeah, no, but my martini's still dry.
Robin Seaton, I think this is it.
Wooshka.
I wasn't aware of this. Rob says Liam Neeson was offered the role but turned it down because it was action. And now, ironically, all he does is action.
Yeah.
He would have been perfect.
Well, he's doing comedy, though, isn't he? He's got that comedy coming out. The Naked Gun. The remake of The Naked Gun.
I tell you, a lot of people are suggesting Stephen Rowe. Ryan as well. Double Kabunsky or You Flog. Yeah, we'll replace Shaken Not Stirred, perhaps. Lots Kabunsky's of good suggestions coming through. We might put them together and collate them very, very shortly. 822-3000 is the number. You can text us on 0448-08-1395 or jump on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream. Let's check... traffic for the first time this hour, and then we'll talk sport in a moment. Keyser, if you're tired of back pain, try Keyser, KIESER.com.au.
Thanks, Will. At Hope Valley, Bruce Water Main, Rosa Wire Road near Berry Road, speeds at 40, affecting both directions. Works at Brooklyn Park, Donald Bradford Drive near Maureen Road, and sluggish at Edwardstown, South Road near Ackland Street, speeds at 40. Slow at the moment, Brighton Road, Brighton, with a camera at Military Road at Grange. Find Easter Savers at IGA, Cadbury Dairy Milk or Red Tulip Hollow Hunting Eggs, 204 grams, $6 each till Tuesday, excludes IGA local grocer and Foodland while stocks last. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
5AA Mornings with Matthew Pantelis.
The Adelaide City Council, with its big rate hike, is looking at whether some projects need to be cut back or scrapped. Roads and rubbish should be the focus. Pet projects by councillors and mayors eager to spend other people's money on nonsense needs to be reined in when they don't have enough money.
Matthew Pantelis.
What a way to keep people out of the city by having the highest rates of any council in the state.
Weekday mornings from 9 on 5AA. Always Adelaide.
Ignition for Men. Adelaide's home of luxury menswear offer an impeccable range of men's attire for work, to celebrate and play. Global brands from E7, Replay, Hugo Boss and Karl Lagerfeld to Canali, Tremorosa Jeans, Emporio Armani and more, including shirts, footwear, jackets and denim. They have it all. If it's casual with style, you'll find it at Ignition for Men, 54 Paynham Road, Stepney, ignitionformen.com.au.
With help from Fluorio Milk Company, cafes all over Adelaide have joined the fight to reduce plastic waste. Instead of single-use plastic bottles, they've introduced reusable 18-litre kegs. Over recent months, a phenomenal amount of single-use plastic bottles have been eliminated, and every day the tally grows. Fluorio Milk Company, together with cafes, supermarkets, schools, restaurants, hotels and workplaces, expect to save our planet from millions of single-use plastic bottles. Visit fluoriomilkco.com.au for more.
See movies how they should be seen. Hear movies how they should be heard. All on the big screen with Quake Sound at Wallace. And now you can see them for less and enjoy candy bar discounts and other special member offers and freebies. Simply become a My Wallace member today. It's free. It's easy and it's full of benefits. Go to wallace.com.au and click on Join My Wallace today. Wallace Mitcham, Mount Barker, Noolunga and the Piccadilly. South Australia's home of big screen magic and entertainment.
The biggest threat to your business isn't your competition. It's cybercrime. Cybercrime threats impacting Australian businesses, large and small, continues to grow year on year. One call to one solution will put your business in a safe place and save you from the devastating consequences of cybercrime. It's the smartest, most cost-effective business decision you'll ever make. Stay safe and protected. Get in touch with One Solution. OneSolution.net.au, a Platinum Telstra partner.
How awesome! Mawson Lakes Volkswagen has plenty of Tiguans and Amaroks in stock. Tiguan Allspace is a seven-seater with plenty of room and plenty of smarts, featuring auto park, adaptive cruise control and lane assist. And the latest generation Amarok has a big one-ton payload and 3.5-ton towing capacity. But inside, you'll get all the comforts of a luxury vehicle. There's plenty of stock that must go. Hurry in for a deal. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen, Salisbury Highway, just a short drive from the city.
Austrac campers have ingenious storage everywhere. Inside, outside, from the front to the back. There's room to put everything you'll ever need. If only I knew where we've kept the spare toilet rolls.
Oh!
Austrac! Rosanna Mangiarelli here from 7 News. Join me and Will Goodings for Adelaide's leading news hour, 7 News, tonight at 6 o'clock.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
27 after 7, always good fun on the sports show. Rowie and Timmy G, $19 schnitty Monday to Wednesday at the Birkenhead Tavern, Excelsior and Lighthouse Wharf. You just know it's a bro hotel. Last night they had a call from Steve from O'Halloran Hill, who came up with a couple of theme song ideas for the new Tassie Devils AFL and AFLW sides. Have a listen.
Let's go to Steve at O'Halloran Hill. G'day, Steve.
G'day, fellas. How are we doing there?
Excellent. What do you got for us?
Oh, mate, I was just sitting here having a couple of sherbet listening to you fellas.
Uh-huh.
And I've got a vast record collection. I was putting the, some plastic sleeves on, and I was going through some records.
Yeah, good.
And I was thinking about the Devils, and I thought, well, In Excess, Devil Inside, what
yes.
a great theme song.
Yes,
that would be.
Steve.
Yeah.
Come on, hum it or sing it with Timmy.
Devil Inside, yeah, all that.
Yeah, and every thought, single one of us, the devil inside.
Yeah.
Oh, well, Steve.
You're onto something there, Steve.
So they run out to that song.
Mm.
I reckon it'd be great. And also, I was going through big records and I came across the Rolling Stones and I thought, when the Devils lose, you could play Sympathy for the Devil.
Yes, another great song.
Steve, I want you to sit in that shed for another hour and ring us at 7 with two more sherbets under your lid, and I reckon we'll get this done.
And I've got another one, Tim. I've got one for the AFLW team. We could go Cliff Richard. Devil Woman.
Devil Woman, there it is.
Just a Devil Woman.
Yeah.
With evil on her mind.
Steve, you're two beers away from being hilarious.
That's awesome. You know what? It is interesting that in the AFL, in Australia, all the songs are sort of custom. They're bespoke. They're made for the clubs.
Mm.
But if you around the world, like in English football, the songs are all, were once just popular. They're just pop songs that took on meaning for certain fan bases.
And really diverse, too. Like, you've got things like Curtis Mayfield, Move On Up.
Yep. Who's that? Da, 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 da.
Yeah.
Which club is that? Arsenal?
Not sure.
Not sure either.
But they all have
Connell, no?
Links to just, you know, pop songs that were good, and then they took on a life of their own.
One of the few clubs that's actually done it well is Port.
Exactly right. Yeah. Port's done it. Maybe Tassie should take a leaf out of that book. I don't mind those ideas.
It's a good name, Devil, because there's heaps of songs with the word Devil
in
the title.
Yeah, works really well. Yeah,
bit of Van Halen, Running with the Devil.
There you go. I knew you'd have fun with this.
Mm. It's one of the good things about Spotify. You can just type in Devil and you get like
5,000 suggestions.
Also a good line about the Devil and the bridge from Taylor Swift's Cruel Summer, which the many people who went to her concert and sang along with that will be familiar with.
You should call into the sports show tonight. 5AA News is coming up. After 7:30, we go around the courts with Sean Fuster.
Mate, it was so easy. Drop the car into Automasters. Next thing, I get a video on my phone.
AutoCam. It's new from Automasters.
The service advisor is there live doing a real-time report on my car.
Real-time video sent direct to you from your Automasters technician.
He shows me the problem, makes a recommendation, and look, there's the quote.
So good. Totally transparent, instant SMS approval, and Automasters pay later options.
AutoCam, the future of vehicle servicing here now. Call 1300 Automasters.
If you need to fix your pipes, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your toilet's blocking up, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your lights aren't turning on, or your hot water is gone, or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Precise.
Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Call 1300 700 200. That's 1300 700 200. For fixed price services, call Precise.
For a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Call Precise.
This is 5AA News. Always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy in 22 today with the 7:30 news. I'm Graham Goodings.
Injured or living with chronic pain? Book an appointment at Physio Extra today. 6 locations. PhysioExtra.com.
A man's been assaulted and had his phone stolen at Mawson Lakes. Senior Constable Rebecca Stokes says he was walking along Sanctuary Drive last night when he was set upon by a group of youths.
He was assisted by members of the public who drove him around the area to look for the offenders and helped him to contact police. The suspects were spotted heading towards the interchange and police were quickly on scene and located three male suspects on Elder Smith Road. The teenagers were 13, 14 and 15. They were all arrested and charged with theft and assault and will appear in the youth court at a later date.
Meantime, court today for three teenagers arrested and charged over a crime spree in the east and northeastern suburbs. Six vehicles were allegedly stolen across 5 days. A Mitsubishi Eclipse, Volkswagen Jetta, Kia Cerato and Land Rover Discovery from properties in Lightsview, Paraka and St George's. And a Porsche and a Mercedes from Leebrook yesterday. Only the latter two have been recovered. Boys aged 13, 15 and 16 have been charged with illegal use of a motor vehicle. The two older boys have also been charged with attempted aggravated serious criminal trespass. Charlie Stevens has been given two lasting legacies by family members. Mel Usher has the story.
Police Commissioner Grant Stevens' teenage son, killed in an alleged hit-run during schoolies last year, has been honoured by his sister. Sophie recently gave birth to a daughter, and Charlie is the newborn's second name. Days earlier, another family member welcomed a boy, and Charles was also chosen as the second name. Commissioner Stevens says it means so much to have Charlie's name live on.
Startling figures from the RAA today. Motorists have shelled out more than $400 million in fines for more than a million speeding offences committed on South Australian roads in the past 5 years. 202,358 speeding fines were issued last year, more than 3,500 more than the preceding year and the highest number since 2020. The huge number of fines has prompted RAA to remind drivers that speeding is one of the fatal five causes of road trauma. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start with a bit of football. Port Adelaide's players will hit the training track this morning as they prepare for Sunday's clash against Richmond at the MCG, which will also be Travis Boak's 350th game. The Power will have to replace Jed McEntee, who will miss the match through concussion. Well, meantime, coach and great Lee Matthews is urging Collingwood not to focus on the 2023 Premiership. The Pies are winless after their first two games ahead of a crunch match against St Kilda on Thursday night. Matthews telling Wide World of Sports both Pies coach Craig McRae and Brisbane coach Chris Fagan need to get back to basics.
But you've got to get your foundations in place. And really, when things aren't going so well, you always got to go back to what are the foundations of your team playing well. I mean, they're probably pretty much the same for all the teams, for that matter. Well, you've got to be good in the contest. You've got to really work hard defensively when it's your turn to work hard.
Let's go to some boxing. Tim Zhu has just 11 days to prepare for a new opponent before his world boxing title goes on the line. The bout with Keith Thurman in Las Vegas has been scratched. That's after the American suffered an injury in training. Tim Zhu says he's now focusing on new opponent Sebastian Fundora, who stands a massive 22 centimetres taller than him.
Obviously disappointed at first because your whole preparation, you're focusing on this one bloke, one style, and then it's just a switch. So my shift has changed. Thurman's out of the picture. I'm on to Fundora now.
I know what it's like to be a lot shorter than someone. He's got a big task ahead there, Graham. That is the 5AA sport.
Good on you, Tom. Now checking 5AA traffic.
Lynn Andrews Real Estate. Experts in commercial and residential property management. LynnAndrews.com.au.
G'day there, Bruce. What am I to look out for today at Hope Valley Reservoir Road near Berry Road? Got speeds at 40. Car rollover at Chain of Ponds at the moment. Torrens Valley Road near Gorge Road causing delays inbound. And got works to look out for at St Mary's today. Road plates in use there. South Road near Princess Parade, speeds at 40. Cameras Bartley Terrace, Westlake Shore and Chief Streets at Brompton. Keep your family safe on the roads these holidays. Pop into Bob Jane T-Mart's for a free tyre safety check. Call 13 26 25 today. I'll look after you. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video. Direct to you from your AutoMaster's technician.
Partly cloudy and 22 today. Tomorrow, sunny 24. And ditto Friday, sunny 24. Saturday, sunny 25. Currently, it's just 12. More news as it happens on 5AA.
It's official, prawn season has begun and SA King Prawns is the place to go for the freshest catch. When Tony, Heather and their crew aren't at sea, they're selling their delicious catch in the SA King Prawn Store in Edinburgh North and SA Farmers Market, Puraka. Pick up 5 kilos of raw prawns from $60. Buy two or more 5 kilo cartons, get $5 off per carton. SA King Prawns, open 6 days at 15 Hewitson Road, Edinburgh North. Sundays only at the SA Farmers Market, Puraka.
Join over 60,000 Adelaide homes and say yes to lowering your energy bills with YES, your energy saving solutions. YES offers a range of money saving solutions to upgrade your home and downgrade your energy bills. With subsidies on ceiling insulation, air conditioning, hot water services and LED lighting installations, rebates on new appliances and incentives for recycling your old fridges, it's easy to say yes to YES. Find out more about your energy saving solutions. Go to yess.net.au.
Pop the car into AutoMasters. Next thing, there's a video on my phone.
Shows me the problem, makes a recommendation, and look, there's the quote.
So good. Totally transparent, instant SMS approval, and AutoMasters pay later options.
AutoCam, new from AutoMasters.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go.
On 5AA Breakfast.
You can watch along on the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook and YouTube live stream. See Sean here in the flesh with us to talk about an issue that we'll get from his perspective, but also we're going to take up with the police commissioner after 8:30 today. And that is the spate of violence we've had in the city and Arundel Mall. Because, Sean, you don't see this, but so much of the text traffic we get and questions from listeners go to, okay, you've reported on it, everyone's outraged, well, what happens next? We lose the thread of some of these stories. So there's one particular case I know that you've been following very closely that was one of the more outrageous occurrences that that took place in the mall.
Yeah, so the case of Trevor John Sansbury, who is the alleged Foot Locker hatchet robber, is actually back in court tomorrow for a decision on bail. So unlike a lot of the other matters we've seen where people have allegedly done things in the mall or on Hindley Street or during the Fringe, been in court and gotten bail straight away. There's actually a bit of a pause here where the magistrate said maybe we should get some reports and maybe we should get some understanding about this man and his circumstances and the potential threat that's posed to the community, if any, before we release him on bail.
So, just remind me, Sean, is this the guy who was arrested first up when the operation started, or...
I believe so, yes. This is the allegation of the man who walked into Foot Locker, took a T-shirt, was confronted as he tried to leave.
I think this might have actually been the day before the operation.
Oh, it was. Okay, it was. Yeah. That's right. It was.
Staff member at Foot Locker says to him, do you want to buy that? And he apparently pulled a hatchet out of his backpack and said, F this, F that, I'm going to effing smash you, I'm going to burn this effing place down, etc. At which point the Foot Locker employee went, go with God, my son.
Step back and let it all happen.
This guy took off and was later found, according to the allegations, wearing the same T-shirt.
Yeah.
So he was arrested and brought before the court. There's some concerns with this gentleman with regard to his mental health.
Mm.
And indeed, while the prosecutor was speaking, talking about why they opposed his release on bail, he started swearing and ranting and raving at the prosecutor through the video link, such that the magistrate actually had to mute the video link.
Mm.
Does that make him mentally ill or just completely antisocial, pain in the...
Yeah.
I
know you're laughing, but literally that's the question.
Yeah,
that's literally the question. You know, we did on Just Lawful 4 weeks about bail and how difficult it actually is, because as a magistrate, you are being presented with the case in its raw form. You know, Gordon Ramsay would throw this back. It's too raw. The whole idea is you're being given the blunt force allegations and you have a very sparse amount of information about the person. The defense counsel has had maybe 5-10 minutes to talk to the client. They haven't had time to actually get proper instructions. The client's not in court for them to speak to them. They're on the video link, so there's no privacy. The whole thing happens really fast. And as a magistrate, you're entitled to take the prosecution case at its highest, assume that, yes, this could be proven beyond reasonable doubt, and make your decision based on that. You've also got to weigh that against community safety. You've also got to weigh that against the person's presumption to be on bail.
So the mental health aspect is clearly a key part.
I think that's the only reason this person is actually still in custody right now.
Right.
Mm, okay. I think everything else, on balance, the magistrate would have gone, I'll give you bail and you can come back on this particular day because you didn't actually hit anybody with the hatchet.
Mm.
You only threatened somebody. And bail should be given to people who are alleged to have voiced threats versus people who have actually caused physical violence.
So is this person getting treatment?
Good question. That's what nobody knows. Okay, at this point.
Right.
Because again, his lawyers are like, we've got mental health
concerns. They might not even know.
But we don't know the answers.
Yeah.
So Magistrate Oliver Cohen's done the absolutely eminently responsible thing and said, going to keep you where you are. Let's find out what your mental health situation is and whether you're getting any treatment.
How often do people blow up in court, yell out things? And
a lot more often than we report it.
Okay.
A lot more often than we report it. And not to excuse anybody's behaviour here, but if you've been locked up, you're in custody, you've had 2 minutes with your lawyer, you walked into a room, you're seeing on a video link what's going on, you may have had no connection to the justice system ever before, it's easy to understand why you'd be frustrated.
Mm.
You want to speak for yourself, you don't know this lawyer, you don't necessarily trust this lawyer. It's not like this is someone that you've had on your books for years. It's often a duty solicitor, and no disrespect to the duty solicitors, but they're trying to deal with 50 to 100 people in a morning. Not just you, and you know, I would be quite frustrated myself, to be honest.
Hey, Sean, can I ask you, in your decades, and they are decades, excellent decades, down there at the Magistrates Court, Samuel A. Building, all of that, covering all the many personages from Adelaide's criminal underclass, have you ever seen anybody go to jail for shoplifting?
For shoplifting? Not on one go, repeatedly. And usually when something else is involved.
Like violence.
Almost always there's an allegation of...
But the actual crime of shoplifting...
Nobody's gone to jail for that I have seen.
Does it feel like word might have got around among our shoplifters that as long as you don't hit anyone, you're never going to go to jail for shoplifting?
Look, that is possible. At the same time, I wonder how much shoplifting is done out of economic desperation versus actual planned aforethought.
Well, some of it.
Yeah, and that's the question that
I've got. Well, that's the sad part of it, and clearly we are in a cost-of-living crisis. But having said that, doesn't matter how good or bad the economy's going, how high or low interest rates are, there's a certain type of person out there who just does it because they want to, and they know that they can probably get away with it.
Well, look, based on the allegations to go with Mr. Sainsbury here, the allegation there is that it was want, take, have.
Yeah.
You know, there wasn't any allegation there of he required the T-shirt in order to go to a job interview or keep up the standard of living or whatever it was. I want that. I'm taking it. If anybody gets in my way, I have a hatchet in my bag. So on that score, it's the hatchet that is the problem in the eyes of the court, not the taking of the T-shirt.
Yeah, yeah. Does the hatchet point to premeditation or what? Those are all questions that will be answered.
Now, his allegation is that I had it for self-defense. So read into that what you will.
From who?
Yeah.
Sean, has anyone ever gone to jail for deflating an inflatable church before?
You know, this is going to be a very, very interesting one. We're talking about Costa Tihalas, and I apologise if I'm mispronouncing that. Costa Tihalas is accused of getting out a knife and slicing up the inflatable church on Light Square. If you don't know what the inflatable church was, it was a fringe installation event kind of thing, like those bouncing castles we have for kids, but it was a church, and people were going in there and getting married, have mass weddings, there's a DJ, things like that. Sort of a cross between the Little Chapel o' Love and an inflatable castle. Mr. Tihalas allegedly did not like this and tried to wreck its air conditioning machine first, and then came in with a knife and slashed the side of it, which of course meant the church came on down. The DJ involved actually gave chase until he realised that Mr. Tihalas was allegedly carrying a knife, and that raised the alarm. Mr. Tihalas was arrested. The issue here for the prosecution in bail was Mr. Tihalas lives on Light Square.
Okay.
And that's where the inflatable church was. So on one ground of things, perhaps he is an aggrieved resident who is sick of the noise that was being made by this fringe venue. On the other side, you don't get to go around just
NIMBY gone wild.
Well, the ultimate NIMBY, really.
Yeah.
On the other, of course, you can't go around slashing up other people's property.
No.
So the prosecution failed in stopping Mr. Tihalas from getting bail. He was received on bail. Was granted bail. But in the end, they said that the only reason that the prosecution were withdrawing their opposition to bail wasn't because of the knife, wasn't because of the allegations of chasing around, wasn't because of the allegations of property damage, but because Mr. Tihalas lives on Light Square and the fringe is now finished. So therefore, the threat of further reoffending is
Makes
gone.
Makes sense. How old was he, did you say?
In his early 20s.
Okay. Do we know if there was any religious sort of motivation to it? Because it did upset a few people.
I've been wondering about that myself.
Yeah.
Yeah, none of that's come out yet again. Bail hearings, 5 minutes of knowledge. But you've got to wonder whether or not the style of the fringe event was part of this. There is more to come on that one as well when we return to court in April. No, not at all. But it's about explanation, isn't it?
Yeah.
In this line of work, it's about explanation, not excuse.
Yeah.
You want to know why things are done and what the justification was.
Yeah.
Unparalleled analysis. Great to have you in, Sean.
Thanks,
appreciate
guys.
It. On your show. Just Lawful, Sunday as well.
Sunday night, doing a case very close to Pembo's heart, the case of A and B and Vivian Dubois, going through that chapter and verse. And you got a bit of a nod on last week's show.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Daniel let me get it through, so there
you go. Good on you, Sean.
Were you trying to hit the dump button?
Well, he was.
That's very kind of you, Sean.
All right, let's check traffic. Thanks to Keyser. If you're tired of back pain, try Keyser at kieser.com.au.
Thanks, Will. At Bedford Park, three-car collision on the Southern Expressway at the Alex Road off-ramp, seeing delays there. Car rollover at Chain of Ponds this morning, Torrens Valley Road near Gorge Road, and a burst water main at Hope Valley, Reservoir Road near Berry Road, speeds at 40. Slow at the moment at Ottaway for Works, Grand Junction Road near Rose Street, with the camera Chief Streets at Brompton. Discover more at Local Sellers, SA's newest locally owned local, now open in Balaclava, Albert Park and Renmark. Visit localsellers.com for great specials. Drink responsibly. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Get a forklift, get a Toyota forklift. Toyota is the world's number one forklift brand, with a great range of pallet jacks, walkie stackers and reach forklifts, right up to their leading Toyota counterbalance forklifts. Legendary reliability and safety, with cleaner, greener electric options, Toyota can tailor the right forklift solution for you. It's all part of the Toyota forklift advantage. For more, visit toyotamaterialhandling.com.au.
Get a Toyota forklift.
NRG Solar have moved to a new location. It's bigger and better, and their new warehouse is fully stocked with wholesale solar and battery equipment. So, if you're looking to save money on electricity and help our environment, don't wait. Visit NRG Solar at their new office on South Road, St Mary's, where every three customers refer someone they know, which means they must be doing something right. Call into NRG Solar at their new premises, 1275 South Road, or visit nrgsolar.com.au.
Samtas Seafoods invite you to savour the finest seafood at unbeatable prices. From now to Easter, continuing their lowest king prawn prices in years, Now, this isn't a typo. Indulge in raw king prawns from the Spencer Gulf, starting at just $13.99 a kilo.
This is they're the only company we always have to double check that there's not typos in the live room.
Yeah, I've often rung the sales reps and said, has Mark lost his mind again at Samtas, or is that actually the price?
They think it's 1974 and not 2024.
That's right.
Experience freshness with local garfish fillets from $43.99. That you can get snapper fillets from $45.99 and delectable King George Whiting fillets from $59.99 a kilo.
And then, of course, their famous deal, 4 kilos snap frozen seafood for just $60. Mix and match your choices. It's an amazing offer.
Treat your family to premium seafood fillets, flathead, ocean trout, barramundi, Atlantic salmon, smooth dory, emperor and more, all in their 4 kilo deal that's still just $60.
Australian prawn meat, scallop meat, octopus, salmon, prawn shazliks, Easter made easy with Samtas Seafoods, Adelaide's King Prawn, freshly opened oyster and fresh seafood specialists.
Factory direct with on-site free parking. Open 7 days. Samtas Seafoods, where value meets quality. 201 Richmond Road, Richmond.
It all started in the back shed. Maybe it started early or late. Either way, the Olympic industry sale means there's no need to wait. With big savings on our entire range of SA engineered sheds, garages, carports and verandas, you can afford to start something big, tough or tasty in your own backyard. Start something with the Olympic industry sale on now.
Austrac Camper's Red Arc battery management system lets you get off the beaten track and off grid for a week, a month.
Will you stop pretending you're in a radio ad?
Or until you get on each other's nerves.
Austrac Campers.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube. Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
Money front as well. To compare, the market economic director and Port Adelaide Football Club boss David Kosh joins us. Morning to you, Koshy.
Morning, gentlemen.
Koshy, have you ever seen anything like the launch of the Tasmanian Devils? What was the target they had for the foundation membership was like 20,000 or something. They've beaten that fivefold.
Yeah, it is just extraordinary. I think it sent a really clear message to this weekend's state election, where both sides of politics are beating their chest and saying, well, you know, we're not sure whether we can afford this new stadium and we're going to renegotiate. And the AFL's saying, well, no, you've signed off on these hurdles to get into it. There's no renegotiation. And the Tasmanian public have said, just get on with it. We want a team. We're prepared to support the team. And I think it's just a fantastic reaction by the grassroots. Forget the politicians jawboning and trying to outdo each other. The person in the street, the silent majority of Tasmanians are saying, yep, we're proud in this state and we want a team to play in the most prestigious sport in the country. And I think for the rest of us in AFL, we say, good on you. We'd love to have you as part of the competition, but understanding, to be part of it, there are certain standards that you've got to keep up in treating your members and all our members as well who travelled to Tasmania to watch the team. But it was just a great reaction.
You're dead right about the silent majority, because I was saying earlier in the show, the fact that both sides of politics in Tasmania are so hostile to this idea, to me it suggests the political class spend an inordinate amount of time talking to inner city whingers who hang around at places like the Salamanca markets, but don't actually talk to normal people who go, how good's the footy? How good's it going to be? When's our stadium going to open?
Exactly. Something to be proud of. The joy, you know, the ups and downs, of course, of following a football team, as we all know, just becomes a centrepiece. Not only for your life, but part of the fabric of your family and the community. It's something special. It's a, It's a bit of magic to follow a team and have a team represent your community. And Tasmanians are incredibly proud of their state, and so they should be, and their community, and they'll be incredibly proud of their club as well. So it's really exciting. But it's, yeah, take the politics out of it. Listen to the normal person in the street, and they have spoken big time.
Koshy, what did you read into the Reserve Bank Governor's press conference yesterday? Rates on hold again. That was no great surprise. I thought some of the candour was interesting post-meeting with regard to things like property prices. Oh, well, we've not had a great track record of predicting them, so we're not going to get into that. And also, the line in the statement that said something to the effect of, well, from this point, anything's possible. They could go up, they could go down, they could stay the same. Hard to draw much insight from that, but it was honest, if nothing else.
Yeah, well, you're quite right when you say, what do you read into the statement of the risk? Because that's what you've got to do. It's like reading tea leaves when that statement comes out from the Reserve Bank. And some really significant changes, though. Almost they're changing, saying, okay, interest rates are a neutral setting. Now, that's really important because up to date, the Reserve Bank has said, hey, we're in tightening mode. That is, that there's likelihood that interest rates could go up again. Now they've slightly tempered the wording in the statement to indicate it's neutral, but then still saying, look, they could do anything. And that's the psychology of markets, psychology of economies. We talk about economies, but the economy is you and me. It's how we behave, how we decide whether we want to go to the shops or not, or whether we want to trade houses or not. So it's all driven by us as consumers and small business owners. Do we put someone else on or not? Am I optimistic, or I am a bit nervous? Now, that's why Michelle Bullock uses language like, hey, we don't know where they're going to go, just to add that uncertainty into our mind, because she doesn't want us to go out and party like it's 1999 and go back to the shops, because that could bring inflation back. So, Rita, we're past the crossroads. You know, we've got the peak of interest rates. They will trend down, probably not as quickly as we all think. Back half of this year, maybe late back half of this year. Inflation could be stickier than we think. But she just wants us to temper those expectations rather than say, right, beauty, peak of the market, rates are coming down, I'm going to go and buy a new house and add to those housing prices increases.
Excellent stuff as always, Dave. David Koch there for Compare the Market Economic Director and, of course, the chairman of the One From One Port Adelaide Football Club. We'll chat again next week, mate.
All right, guys. Look forward to it.
Cheers.
Got a text from Phil on the Dutton's text line a short time ago saying it's Equinox Day, which means today summer is finally over. And I've got to say, it does feel like that a bit outside at the moment. Jade Robren is out on the road for us, thanks to Dutton's, with all the weather information. Morning to you, Jade.
Good morning, guys. Yes, let's settle this debate, because there is a team of people that think, yes, autumn starts today, but a big group says that it starts at the beginning of March. So, as you mentioned, it is the autumn equinox today. So at 1:36, Wednesday the 20th, so today, there'll be a solar equinox. Now, what does that mean? Well, it's a moment in time when the sun crosses the Earth's equator, which means it appears directly above the equator. So rather than north or south of the equator, it happens today and also on the 23rd of September. So today will also feel like the day and the night is about the same length. So sunrise today was at 7:19 a.m. Sunset tonight will be around 7:28 p.m. But I'm on the beautiful Prescott Terrace in Rose Park, and if you've driven down here in autumn, it's absolutely stunning with all the trees in the middle of the road and on the side of the roads. But at the moment, they are still looking very green and quite lush, not quite ready to turn to that beautiful orange and drop their leaves just yet. But if you do Google when autumn starts, it does say today in the southern hemisphere, and Mother Nature has turned on a crisp autumn morning. morning. It's 12 degrees right now, but if you're out and about, it feels more like 10 degrees. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm ready for some cooler months. I'm not interested in watching footy when it's 35 degrees. Let's take a look, though, at the average March temperatures. So the average March day in 2023 was 25 degrees. Now, the average overnight temp dropped to 14.5. Rainfall was at around 34.2 millimetres. Now, the hottest day in March in 23 was Friday the 17th. That came in at 33.6. So we've already smashed those days here in March this year. The coldest day in March in 23 was Wednesday the 8th. It dropped to minus 20.5. No, that has to be a typo.
What?
Coldest day. No, it can't.
Minus 20? Sam said...
No, yes, never. Quickly. No, no, it definitely couldn't have been.
Saskatchewan?
I'd be given false information. Anyway, moving right along. This week, tomorrow is 22 degrees, Friday 23 degrees, Saturday 23 degrees, Sunday 22 degrees on Sunday. So definitely cooler weather on the way. Open fire, footy and red wine time.
Beautiful.
Bring it on.
You were just making sure people were paying attention at home, Joe.
Yeah. I was, and you two were listening to me, so thank you so much.
No, magnificent.
Well, you picked
work.
It
we
up on
do.
The fly, Joe. You did a much better job than I did earlier, saying that there were about 9,000 people at the Melbourne v Footscray game on the weekend. Terry and Henley Beach are still laughing about that one.
We'll check in with Jade again before 9 o'clock.
Terry's never been wrong in his entire life. You know that? He's amazing. You've got to meet him. I really want to meet him one day.
5AA News is coming up. Break your note next.
When you die, who gets what? Will your kids or relatives argue over your estate? Will your beneficiaries be protected? Will your estate be tax effective? Will your wishes be respected and carried out? Speak with Donlan Lawyers now for peace of mind. Donlan Lawyers, for wills and estate planning. Visit donlanlawyers.com. That's donlanlawyers.com.
Up to the minute news for South Australia. This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy and 22 today with the 8 o'clock news. Good morning, I'm Graham Goodings.
Physio, Pilates, hydro, massage, podiatry and exercise classes. Physio Extra's holistic care. PhysioExtra.com.
Three boys aged 13, 14 and 15 have been arrested, accused of mugging a man at Mawson Lakes. He was walking along Sanctuary Drive last night when he was assaulted and had his mobile phone stolen. Police caught up with the teenagers heading towards the interchange. They've been charged with theft and assault and will face the youth court at a later date. Meantime, three boys, the youngest just 13, will front court today over a crime series involving half a dozen cars. Mel Usher reports.
It's been revealed a Porsche and Mercedes stolen from Leabrook yesterday and later found dumped at Gillis Plains were part of a crime series. They've been linked to four other cars taken from various addresses since last Friday. A Mitsubishi Eclipse, Volkswagen Jetta, Kia Cerato and Land Rover Discovery were stolen from properties in Lightsview, Paraka and St George's. Those four cars are yet to be recovered. Three boys, a 13-year-old from Dufferin Park, 15-year-old from Holden Hill and 16-year-old from Flinders Park, have been charged with illegal use of a motor vehicle, the two older boys further charged with attempted aggravated serious criminal trespass. They'll appear in the youth court today.
The by-election battle for Dunstan has taken another turn. Labor candidate Cressida O'Hanlon has claimed she had nothing to do with her husband's business Citadel Secure, despite being listed on the website as a senior associate. It follows questions about Liberal candidate Anna Fenizio's links to a failed family business, Formway Group. Dunstan voters will go to the polls this Saturday. Some economists predict the Reserve Bank could start cutting rates sooner rather than later. The board kept rates on hold at 4.35% yesterday and says it's not ruling out a further hike. But AMP Chief Economist Shane Oliver has told Today the general outlook is positive.
The consensus amongst economists in the money markets is for a cut around August, September, the first cut around then. We think it could come a little bit earlier as inflation continues to surprise on the downside, so we're looking for around June.
The Nationals and the Greens have joined forces to try to break up the major supermarket chains over price gouging allegations. Coles and Woolworths are accused squeezing farmers and customers in a bid to increase their profits. The minor parties believe both companies need to have less power. National Senator Matt Canavan says the proposed breakup laws may make the supermarket chains see their senses.
These laws are exactly what exists in the US, in the UK, in Europe and Canada. Almost all developed countries have these powers. They'd only be used sparingly, just the threat of them would encourage better behaviour from our major supermarket.
Major alcohol retailers are leaving mandatory pregnancy warnings off their websites. The George Institute analysed several websites, finding just 7% had the labels displayed on their main page. Consuming alcohol during pregnancy can cause long-term harm and permanent brain damage to unborn children. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Agostino Mitsubishi's Good To Go giveaway is on now. Receive a bonus $2,000 fuel card on 2023 build Triton.
And now here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Adelaide forward Taylor Walker has taken a big step towards playing in Friday night's clash against Geelong. That's after getting through last night's training session. The 33-year-old looked solid during the session and the club will now wait to see how he pulls up today. Port Adelaide's players will train this morning ahead of Sunday's clash against Richmond at the MCG. It's promising to be an emotional build-up for Travis Boak, with the 35-year-old set to play his 350th game against the Tigers. And Hawthorn captain James Sicily is free to play on Saturday against Melbourne. That's after successfully downgrading a one-match suspension to a fine for kicking. The Socceroos are determined to secure qualification for the FIFA World Cup as quickly as possible, having gone the long way for the past two tournaments. They take on Lebanon tomorrow night at Western Sydney Stadium in the first of two matches against the country. Coach Graham Arnold has told Today he'd love to avoid another penalty shootout during an intercontinental playoff.
I'm pretty sure I don't want to go through that one again. So, you know, the main focus for the boys is obviously direct qualification. We're on top of our group. We win these two games, we go right through to the next phase.
Cameron Bancroft has been ruled out of the Sheffield Shield final after falling off his bike. He suffered a concussion. It's a major blow for WA ahead of their clash with Tasmania starting tomorrow. And Australia's been handed a tough draw at the Davis Cup in tennis, grouped with host nations Spain, the Czech Republic and France. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Thanks, Tom. Now checking 5AA traffic.
Lynn Andrews Real Estate, experts in commercial and residential property management. lynnandrews.com.au.
Morning there at Bedford Park, at a three-car collision to look out for this morning. It's on the Southern Expressway just near the Alice Road off-ramp. Got a car all over at Chain of Ponds causing a few dramas today. Torrens Valley Road near Gorge Road and a burst water main at Hope Valley Reservoir Road near Berry Road. Slow going Brighton Road at Glenelg South with the Camera Chief Street at Brompton. Tired of feeling tired? Get free local delivery at Amart plus removal of your old mattress when you spend $999 or more on a new one. In-store only at Amart. T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video. Direct to you from your AutoMaster's technician.
22 and partly cloudy today. Tomorrow, sunny 24. Likewise, Friday, sunny 24. Saturday, sunny 25. Right now, it's 12. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Get obsessed with the Honda SUV range at Formula Honda, Modbury and Glen Osmond. Whether it's the compact HR-V, the sporty mid-sized Honda ZR-V, or the spacious CR-V. And for a limited time, new Honda SUVs come with a 7-year warranty, 7-year roadside assist, and 5 standard low-price services at $199 each. Visit Formula Honda, Modbury or Glen Osmond and test drive today. Vehicles used for a commercial purpose have a 7-year or 200,000-kilometre warranty, whichever occurs first. T's and C's at honda.com.au.
Remember when milk came in bottles? I mean real glass bottles. It somehow tasted better, and it was better for the planet. That's why the Fleurio Milk Company have brought it back. Milk in a glass bottle. Thanks to you, the reduction in single-use plastic bottles is already proving phenomenal, and the numbers continue to grow. Join the fight to reduce plastic single-use bottles and look for milk refill stations in your supermarket. Visit fleuriomilkco.com.au for more.
You've decided to build? It's exciting stuff. When you've found land, it's a good idea to get advice on what you can build on your new parcel of paradise. Get Steve from Beechwood Homes to take a look. There's no obligation and you'll get a great understanding of what's possible. Sloping block, flat block, weird shape block, or block on a cliff. Speak with Steve from Beechwood Homes for all the possibilities. Life's good. It's even better in a Beechwood home. Google Beechwood Adelaide.
Stay informed, get involved.
FIVEAA, always Adelaide. I'm on top of the
world, hey. Ray White Business Sales. Business.
Joshua Shelley from the Adelaide Football Club, not too far away.
Give us the tea, Adelaide.
If you're watching along on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream, we've been joined live in the studio by a black kettle from Smeg. It looks magnificent. We love their stuff. Quality stuff. I have that kettle, actually, not that specific.
What colour's yours?
No, black, that one.
Really?
Yeah, not that one, but, you know, one, sexy. One of that likeness.
They are good, aren't they?
They're the best.
Beautiful Italian design, very sleek. None of these stupid buttons, like, you know, the toasters where it's like, you know, would you like it 97%
charge? Yeah, none of that rubbish. If you'd like to win it, all you need to do is provide us with a rumour. What have you been hearing out there, folks? If you've got an ear to the ground and you've heard a rumour about something that's happening, something that's not happening, perhaps, something that is of statewide importance or just of interest to you and your local area, whatever it might well be, get calling now, 8223-0000. You can remain totally anonymous and we'll award the Smeg kettle by 9 o'clock this morning.
Well, Ziz Genos is one of Adelaide's most respected property developers. He's also not a man who normally courts publicity. In fact, this will be the first time in my 30-year career as a journalist that I've ever spoken to him. But the reason we have Ziz on the line now is that he's made an extraordinary intervention in the debate by the Adelaide City Council over whether it is going to go ahead and increase council rates by a staggering 7.4%, regardless of the fact that this will obviously have an extraordinarily negative effect on a business community that's already doing it tough. Ziz, good morning, and thank you so much for joining us for this special Breaking at 8. Now,
good morning.
I understand that yesterday you took the step of writing to the Lord Mayor and every single Adelaide City Councillor reminding them of this. The council needs to be reminded that without business, the city dies. Remember COVID, when the real assistance to business was provided by landlords. It is obvious that the council is oblivious to the adverse impact that such an increase will have on business and also on the community in general. It's a very strong letter. Do you think that the council is going to heed your warning?
I doubt it. They don't seem to take notice of anything. They just bulldozed through. And unfortunately, it led me to write such a letter in the hope that maybe somebody could take note. Already a couple of councillors have responded, but that's all, you know. Generally, nobody really responds.
One point you make too in the letter, Ziz, and as a writer, I got to say, it was a killer last sentence. You said the contemplated increases are bad enough, but to apply the money to plant trees at $20,000 per tree and to erect a statue, it does seem weird that at the same time the council's saying we've only got a finite amount of money, that they can still... And, I don't know anyone who's ever paid $20,000 for a tree. It just seems to be an extraordinary double standard.
Well, I think it's a ridiculous situation. If you don't have money, you don't spend that type of money planting trees and building statues. And I think the council should appreciate and be told that business and the community are not a bottomless pit that they can put their hands in whenever they like to increase rates and levies and fees and whatever else you might call it. I think enough is enough. The increases that they got through revaluations, et cetera, are big enough in themselves without having this additional burden that everybody will carry.
One other thing is the role that you play with the Genos Group, property development. You're also you also own a lot of buildings that have a lot of tenants that provide vibrancy to the city. I'm thinking restaurants in Weymouth Street, in some property that you acquired there. What's your reading of how resilient those smaller businesses are at the moment to these types of rate imposts?
Well, small businesses like that have had a large downturn in their business, arising from a lack of people, working from home, etc. But increases in rates is just another nail. Everybody's working hard to keep their businesses open. You read every day that people are closing their restaurants, their shops, etc. And all the council wants to do is plant trees at rates that are laughable at best.
And just finally, do you ever think it's at the point where we actually need a bigger and maybe harder conversation about the way the city's actually run? I mean, do you think there's almost an argument for the state government stepping in and saying these people are amateurs and can't be trusted to run the joint?
I think it's essential that the government steps in, and the sooner the better, and get some order into the system, because at the moment it seems that the whole council issue comprises of mismanagement and one could almost say incompetence, although there are some very good, competent people that work in the council.
Since Gene,
I think the government's got to do it sooner rather than later.
Yeah, it's a view that I've heard from a lot of people in business who employ a lot of people. They're really worried about the impact that's having. Ziz, as I said at the start, I've never spoken to you before. The letter was excellent. You spoke for a lot of people, and we'll keep pursuing this issue. Thanks for joining us this morning for Breaking at 8.
Thank you for having me.
It's a pretty massive intervention. Like, that guy is not even close to being a household name. I've had three of the biggest property figures in Adelaide contacting me in the last 24 hours going, this is beyond a joke.
What becomes of the city, too, if those kind of people decide?
Well,
there's no point.
You know the other thing? This 150 grand for the Barry Humphrey statue.
Mm.
You know what the original plan was? And it's just as symbolic, and it will probably cost you $100, to just change the name of the road between the Metropolitan Hotel and Her Majesty's to Humphrey's Lane.
Beautiful.
You put up a lovely new sign. Idea. Why not do that?
Mm.
The other thing, I've heard that the councillor who put the motion to spend $150,000 on the Barry Humphrey statue, Carmel Noon, is also involved with Her Majesty's Theatre in a fundraising capacity.
Right.
So how is it that on one hand you're trying to raise money to help Her Majesty's Theatre, but then you're also a councillor? I mean, I suppose it makes the fundraising easier if you can just get the ratepayers to pay for the statue.
A powerful fundraiser, doesn't it?
Makes you a very effective fundraiser. That's an odd... I'm not saying it's illegal or improper, but it does look like it is potentially some kind of a conflict.
Yeah, it's the kind of thing you'd imagine people would recuse themselves from the debate over, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
If that came up. Look, I'm actually involved with it.
It'd be like this Smeg kettle I'm holding here. Mm. I've heard a rumour. Well, that what I just said was a rumour.
Mm.
Maybe I should win the Smeg kettle.
I mean, it was a good rumour.
Yeah.
But it doesn't feel right, does it? It doesn't feel right.
I'm taking the kettle.
Actually, we're getting a lot of good rumours coming through at the moment, I can see. 8223 00 00. If you would like to win it, we'll award it by 9 o'clock and get to some of your rumours very shortly. Coming up next on the program, Josh Rochelli from the Adelaide Football Club will join us. Let's check traffic. Thanks to Keyser. If you're tired of back pain, try Keyser. Keyser.com.au.
Thanks, Will. At Bedford Park, three-car collision on the Southern Expressway at the Alice Road off-ramp, seeing delays inbound. Channa Ponds, car rollover on Torrens Valley Road near Gorge Road. Bruce Woodermain slowing things up at Hove Valley. Reservoir Road near Berry Road speeds at 40, and a smash at Erbray, Fullerton Road at Kitchener Street. Slow going Brighton Road, Brighton, with a camera trimmer parade at Findon. The Audi 48-hour sale event is coming. Enjoy 7 years scheduled servicing and 7-year warranty on selected models. Starts Thursday at your preferred Audi dealer. T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The 5AA Sports Show.
Stephen Rowe and Tim Jennifer.
Channel 9's very own Eddie McGuire. Eddie, welcome.
Great to be with you. Can't wait for Gather Round. It, in 1 year, has become just a fan favourite, hasn't it? It's just absolutely sensational. And we're going to come over and have a bit of fun and showcase South Australia right around the country.
Oh, it'll be great.
The 5AA Sports Show.
Absolutely focused on South Australia. We're going to cross to all the great areas.
Weekdays from 4 p.m. on 5AA. Always Adelaide.
Jarvis Toyota has moved to their brand new home in Brighton Road, Somerton Park. So now is the time to take advantage of opening savings across the entire Hilux range, including the Hilux GR Sport. Hilux, the unbreakable connection since 1968, will be stronger than ever with the first ever Hilux GR Sport. Inspired with Dakar DNA. Available now and boasting more power and torque. Jarvis Toyota, now at Brighton Road, Somerton Park. Proudly celebrating 22 years of great deals.
Thinking about a solar battery? Don't wait. Connect with NRG Solar and bring home a solar battery with a rock-solid 10-year warranty. Use the energy you generate during the day. Store some for later, reducing reliance on energy providers and putting money back in your pocket. See NRG Solar in their new premises at St Mary's. Bigger place, better space, some amazing people. Visit NRG Solar now at 1275 South Road or call 1300 858 160.
Now, home maintenance is exhausting. I'd go further. I'd say it's befuddling. I don't know where to start with that sort of stuff. You need to know a plumber, an electrician, a handyman and a renovator, or you could swap all those numbers for just one, the great people at Precise Plumbing and Electrical.
Yeah, this is good. The proverbial one-stop shop. From plumbing and electrical work to pipe relining, bathroom renovations and handyman services, they're the only number you ever need to know, and they've got 25 years worth of happy customers.
And look, they'll service all areas of Adelaide and be on time every time with an expert in your field of need, ready to do top-notch work. In fact, they're so confident in their expertise, their workmanship comes with a lifetime warranty.
That's right. With free quotes and upfront fixed pricing, Precise Plumbing Electrical is a name you can trust. And frankly, it's the only name you need to remember. Visit preciseservices.com.au.
City Discount Tires. Get saving this month at City Discount Tires. Grab three Falcon Zeek ZE310R passenger car tires and get the fourth tire absolutely free. Experience top-notch performance with exceptional grip on both wet and dry surfaces. Steer your way to citydiscounttires.com.au for even more great deals. City Discount Tires. We're driven by value. City Discount
Tires. In tough times, it's the simple things that make a big difference. Like $19 schnitzel days at the Birkenhead Tavern, Excelsior and the Lighthouse Wharf. We know the humble schnitty can't fix all our problems, but we do know it'll put a smile on your dial. $19 schnitty, Mondays, Tuesdays and Wednesdays at the Birkenhead Tavern, Excelsior and the Lighthouse Wharf. Making the world a better place, one schnitty at a time. Gotta start somewhere. You just know it's a Barrow Hotel.
When you're gone, who gets the things most precious to you? Like your highly valued comic book collection or your 1976 Tirana in mint condition? If you don't have a will, you'll never know. Donlan Lawyers specialise in wills and estate planning. From the simplest to the most complex, Donlan Lawyers will give effect to your wishes. For wills and estate planning, visit donlanlawyers.com. Hindmarsh Square, Adelaide and Ocean Street, Victor Harbour.
Rosanna Mangiarelli here from 7 News. Join me and Will Goodings for Adelaide's leading news hour, 7 News, tonight at 6 o'clock.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on. Touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
He's class personified.
Oh, he had us losing our voice on Saturday night in that last quarter when the impossible comeback for a brief moment looked like it might come about. Josh Rochelli joins us live in the 5AA Breakfast Studio. Josh, good morning to you, mate.
Good morning, Dad Will.
Great to have you here, mate. It's always glass half full, glass half empty, looking back on a footy game. Half empty is where were you for three quarters, but half full is, geez, if you can only play for like less than one quarter and almost win, then there's some positives to come out of it.
Yeah, definitely some positives, definitely.
It was a weird game, wasn't it? It's sort of, we're just chatting before out in the lift, and did it feel a bit like the game started and you guys went, oh, geez, that's right, the footy season's underway.
It was a little bit like that. We started and it was weird. We had like the same inside 50s, contested numbers were the same, but it felt like every time we go inside 50, just slingshot straight back out and every time Gold Coast get it, they were kicking goals and we weren't. And to look at the scoreboard at halftime and only kick one goal was, yeah, a bit disappointing.
And they obviously had, you know, with the bizarre round A, round zero, whatever you call it, they were on from the start. It was probably an advantage for them being their second match of the year.
Oh, I think so. I think round one, normally when two teams have come off pre-season, it's a bit even. They don't really, they're still working things out. But for us, yeah, to go straight in and those slippery, wet conditions that Gold Coast adapted to a lot quicker than us was, yeah, a bit hard.
I'm sure you've seen the footage. I've got to ask you, did you receive a bake from Nixie on the bench?
I've watched it so many times, and I don't know if I was in the zone or nothing, but I cannot remember him yelling at me at all. Because he's got his finger up spraying.
Yeah, it looked like, you're just, you're just focused. Just,
yeah, whatever. It looked bad. But yeah, it wasn't like that.
Does he talk a lot on the bench when you come off and give instruction, or does he leave you to your devices usually?
Yeah, he's good. He normally likes us to problem solve, so he kind of asks us questions. So if I'm in the forward line, he'll go, Josh, what's going on in the mids, or what's going on in the backs, or if there's a message to pass on. But yeah, obviously, okay, if he sees something, he'll tell it straight away.
Do you, that last quarter, you speak about feeling in the zone in that moment on the bench. Do you feel hot? Like, you know, you often talk about basketball as getting the hot hand. Do you feel like that in a game? You go, if I'm anywhere inside 450, I'm on at the moment.
Definitely when I kicked that goal in the third quarter siren, it just gave me a little bit of confidence. Mm. And knowing there wasn't many contested big marks on the day, forward 50, the ball was always going to drop short or go over the back. So it felt a little bit predictable being a small forward. So I did feel, yeah, a little bit hot. And for Isaac and when Jake Sligo came on as well, I don't know, it just felt that bit of momentum.
He really gave you something, Jake, when he came on, didn't he? He looked terrific.
He did. It's hard being a sub. I played it last year for a game, and just to be in the moment for the whole four quarters, you don't know if you're going to come on the first or the fourth. So it's quite hard because you can go either way. You can come on really well and dominate, or you can go, oh, I've been waiting the whole time, and all that nervous energy kind of just wrecks you the whole day, and then you go on that fourth quarter and it's hard to impact at times.
What's been the internal discussion around the game, Josh? Like, you know, what's Nixie's message been about it? Because obviously the fans are all, oh, you know, we're meant to be top eight, and, you know, that's it, season over. You know, like, how do you deal with it internally?
Oh, first of all, we just say we take a chill. It's like it's a one game. We've got another 20-something games left, and you see Collingwood and Brisbane, these guys go 0-2. So we relax. It's obviously not ideal to lose and to start how we did, but we just go back and we looked at a few things we could have changed structurally at the time, and probably how we could have adapted to the wet weather. I felt like Gold Coast straight away, their skills were a lot better. They played more for stoppage football, more contested. We'll probably still thinking it was a bit dry weather. And yeah, I think if we could have shifted that a bit earlier in the game, things could have changed.
And you have the Texan up front keeping you company this Friday night?
I think so, yeah. He trained yesterday, trained really good. So I think it'll just be in his hands now if he's physically up to it.
Mm. Are you excited about the prospect of Friday night footy? Because Friday night and Thursday night haven't been a big part of the Crows fixturing since you've been at the club, but this year's very different.
Yeah, I absolutely loved it. I love that we've got a few of those games this year, especially last year with a bit of experience and gather around on that Thursday night was just unbelievable to play on prime time. So to have more of them games this year, I'm definitely looking forward to it.
Yeah, the Thursday night games, I love those Thursday night games. Yeah. It's always a bit of a party atmosphere.
Does it? Is it a different vibe on those sort of nights? It feels like when you're a fan, you turn
it
up those
It is on
nights.
The hill.
Yeah. Well, it does. People have come in from work and, you know, the weekend hasn't officially started. It feels, the atmosphere feels somehow different. Do you feel that as a player?
It does. And especially like last night, we trained, we had our main training at Adelaide Oval. And even that, like, guys are sore. We've only played a few days ago, but just that energy and excitement that you're back at Adelaide Oval and you're playing prime time in hopefully it's 40, 45,000 fans, home Adelaide fans. So I know a lot of us small forwards, myself, Isaac, we love to play in the big crowds.
Now, reminded me, I've been wanting to ask this of an actual Crows player for a while. There's obviously lots of discussion politically and at the council level and the community level about the Theberton upgrade. For the players, when you look at, like, you know, Collingwood's got the Emirates where, you know, you get a sore toe and there's 18 masseuses on standby to give you a rub down, you know, protein shakes on arrival, all the rest of it. You guys were playing in a place that looked like Mogadishu, training in a place that looked like Mogadishu for a long time. Is it something where the players are like at a point where it's like, when are we going to get this? You know, you must be getting a bit antsy about it.
Yeah, it's weird. When my first day I rocked up at the club, I thought AFL facilities would look amazing going in.
Not, and they gave you a dust
not
mask.
Not to hear, not going like, well, what's going on here? But they were still knocking down the rest of the back. But it's so funny. As soon as you go inside, the facilities are still, they're elite. Like our gym is probably one of the best still. We've got, it's so big. Our change rooms and stuff, everything's pretty cool. But to see the new to see the new plan of how our next facility is going to look, I think it's definitely going to be one of the best in the AFL.
Yeah, it's very exciting.
Are you going to get your name on the honour board as the leading goal kicker this year? Because you're leading after round one.
Three. It was awesome.
I think I was leading last year too, and I went downhill pretty quickly. So I'm just keeping my head on my shoulders this year.
Don't peak too early.
Yeah, that's
exactly right.
Right.
Well, mate, all the best. Friday night, massive game against the Cats. Looking forward to it, and hopefully you can turn it on again.
Yeah, hopefully. Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me.
Cheers, Josh. Thanks, mate.
The police commissioner will join us right after 5AA News.
If you want to save serious money on your hot water bills, get off the gas. I know what you're thinking, but gas is better. Not anymore. EcoVantage can show you how a heat pump hot water system can save you up to 50% on your water heating costs. That's up to 50%. It's a huge saving. And now it's more affordable than ever to make the switch. Get off the gas to heat your water and get onto EcoVantage. EcoVantage.com.au.
Steinbonner Automotive has always been well worth the trip. And now there's Barossa Mazda, Murray Street, Nuriapa. SA's newest Mazda dealership is now open. For 40 years, Steinbonner has provided South Australians with outstanding customer service, exceptional value, and a large selection of new, used, and demo vehicles. The Steinbonner story continues with the opening of their new state-of-the-art Mazda dealership in Barossa Valley. Barossa Mazda. It's well worth the trip. BarossaMazda.com.au.
Built like a brick house. Basic Trailers build all types of trailers here in Adelaide. Locally made with Australian steel, you get 12 months warranty and factory direct pricing. Visit BasicTrailers.com.au. Basic Trailers. Basically, better.
Roll up, roll up. Elmo's Circus Dream is coming to Adelaide for the first time.
Catch all the fun of this fantastic theatre show with Elmo and his Sesame Street friends, including Abby Cadabby, Bert and Ernie, Cookie Monster and more.
Rubber ducky, you're the one.
My brother bought Rosie a little Bert. She's got a little Bert.
Oh, really?
Yeah. We just walk around going, hey, Bert.
Yeah.
There's also amazing circus stars performing acrobatics, illusions, creating plenty of laughs, so expect to be on the edge of your seat.
Join Elmo and his gang of friends in this very immersive show as they discover their own hidden circus talents with singing, dancing and much more.
It promises to be an unforgettable day of great family fun at Elmo's Circus Dream in Adelaide for a limited time from March 30. For more information and to purchase tickets, visit sesamestreetcircus.com.au.
This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Partly cloudy and 22 today with the 8:30 news. I'm Graham Goodings.
Injured or living with chronic pain? Book an appointment at Physio Extra today. 6 locations, physioextra.com.
A new report claims hospital staff in the UK tried to access the Princess of Wales medical records at a London clinic. Royal editor at The Mirror, Russell Myers, says at least one staff member has been allegedly caught trying to access the Royal's medical information amid secrecy surrounding her abdominal surgery.
In the UK, this is actually classed as a criminal matter, and we've spoken to the Metropolitan Police tonight. Scotland Yard haven't confirmed whether they are involved, but I think that they will have to come out and say something, whether the hospital has let them know that this investigation is taking place. You know, and this member of staff, who I understand has been suspended, will obviously have to face the internal investigation and then potentially a police investigation as well.
Charlie Stevens has been given two lasting legacies by family members. Mel Usher has the story.
Police Commissioner Grant Stevens' teenage son, killed in an alleged hit-run during schoolies last year, has been honoured by his sister. Sophie recently gave birth to a daughter, and Charlie is the newborn's second name. Days earlier, another family member welcomed a boy, and Charles was also chosen as the second name. Commissioner Stevens says it means so much to have Charlie's name live on.
A man's been arrested after he was seen acting suspiciously in Glenelg North this morning. Senior Constable Rebecca Stokes says they were called to Adelphi Terrace just after 2 a.m.
It will be alleged that in his possession we found a small amount of methamphetamine and two ice pipes. And police checks revealed he was also wanted for a number of outstanding matters. He's a 21-year-old Manipara man. He's been arrested and charged with illegal interference with vehicles, possessing controlled drugs and possessing drug equipment.
Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump has unloaded on Australia's ambassador, Kevin Rudd. Trump is campaigning for a second term in the White House. He had a good relationship with our previous ambassador, Joe Hockey. But Trump has told British broadcaster GB News, Australia's current representative in Washington may not be welcome for much longer.
I don't know much about him. I heard he was a little bit nasty. I hear he's not the brightest bulb, but I don't know much about him. But if he's at all hostile, he will not be there long.
Almost 4 in 10 Australians over the age of 55 have delayed or put off going to the dentist due to the cost. New data from Council on the Ageing shows 73% of people would support a scheme to provide older Australians with quality, affordable dental care. Council Chief Executive Patricia Sparrow says millions are putting their health at risk.
What we want is a scheme that all older Australians can access, a seniors dental benefits scheme, to so that make sure that they can get quality, affordable dental care when they need it, and it should be covered through Medicare.
Stage 4 of the Amy Gillett Bikeway is set to proceed after a funding agreement was reached. The Adelaide Hills Council, state and federal governments will jointly fund the project. It'll see the bikeway extended by around 6 kilometres from Mount Torrens to Birdwood in the Adelaide Hills. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Agostino Mitsubishi's Good To Go giveaway is on now. Receive a bonus $1,000 fuel card on 2023 Build Outlander.
And now here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Graham. Adelaide forward Josh Rochelli admits it may have been a disadvantage playing against a side that had played a game the week before. The Gold Coast Suns had a first-up win against Richmond before facing the Crows, and Rochelli has told David and Will that may have been a help for them.
Round one, normally when two teams have come off pre-season, it's a bit even. They're still working things out. But for us, yeah, to go straight in and those slippery, wet conditions that Gold Coast adapted to a lot quicker than us was, yeah, a bit hard.
The Crows are hopeful Taylor Walker will play on Friday night against Geelong, and the veteran got through training last night. Well, Collingwood defender Jeremy Howe concedes the Magpies' ball movement hasn't been up to scratch in their opening two games. The Pies have conceded 100 points in both losses. Howe telling Fox Footy they're confident things will turn around.
I felt like the way that we used the ball, we probably went out, adjusted the balance a little bit too much, had some howling turnovers that just weren't able to defend. And to be honest, like, the Giants and Sydney both played incredible games against us.
This weekend, Aussie F1 driver Daniel Ricciardo will have a 10th tilt at the Australian Grand Prix, and he says he's excited to return to his home race and has his sights set on a top 10 finish. And the International Olympic Committee has ruled Russian and Belarusian athletes will not take part in the opening ceremony in Paris. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Thanks, Tom. Now checking 5AA traffic.
Lynn Andrews Real Estate. Experts in commercial and residential property management. lynnandrews.com.au.
Morning there at Bedford Park. Three-car collision on the Southern Expressway at the Alice Road off-ramp. Seeing delays inbound there. Glen Smash on Paynham Road near Glenburn Road. Also solid delays. And a car roll over a chain of ponds, Torrens Valley Road near Gorge Road. Another smash at Erbray. This one's on Fullerton Road at Kitchener Street, causing delays. Busy Brighton Road, Brighton, with a camera, Hawker Street at Brompton. Amazon's Big Smile sale is live now. Shop epic deals on electronics, homewares, beauty and more. Shop Amazon's Big Smile sale now at Amazon.com today. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
And now the 5AA forecast.
See any issue firsthand with AutoCam. Real-time video. Direct to you from your AutoMasters technician.
Partly cloudy and 22 today. Tomorrow, sunny 24. Friday, sunny 24. Saturday, sunny 25. Right now, it's 13. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base. Search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
23 minutes tonight. If you're watching along on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream, you'll note we've been joined in the studio by the Police Commissioner, Grant Stevens, and it's a big congratulations to you, Commissioner, for becoming a grandfather again.
Thank you, Will. It's a pretty pleasant way to be reminded that you're closer to the finish line than you are the start line.
And all of the fun and none of the responsibility, grandkids.
Yeah, well, it is good to be able to hand it back. I've heard that said so many times.
Yeah.
But, especially our oldest grandchild now is just turned two.
Yeah, right.
And, he can test your patience, even as a grandparent. So he's a great little kid, but he's feeling his way and stamping his authority on the family. And
you want kids like that, though. My grandma used to say you can knock the life out of them, you can't knock the life into them.
Nah, this one's full of life. So
yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And Annabelle's just gorgeous. She's just a great little arrival. And you know, with Dusty, our niece's little boy arriving 2 days before, I think these two are going to grow up very closely together. And yeah, we're pretty excited about it all.
Yeah, no, it's excellent. Happy, it's a happy news story, and we always love happy news stories here. Hey, Commissioner, a much less happy story, and a lot of it I'm not so. Unfortunately, your line of work, this is inevitable.
It's a bit of a theme, isn't it? Yeah.
Comes with being the police commissioner.
Yeah, that's right.
Nothing good, nothing bad happened in Adelaide last night. How about that? Yeah. I don't think that's ever been said.
No, we occasionally, when we crossed to SOPOL at 6:45, we've had a couple of days.
They've gone, it's nothing.
Where they've just said, there's nothing from overnight. And, you know, let's remember, sometimes that does happen in Adelaide.
That's a good thing.
But it hasn't been happening for the last couple of weeks in the city. We had that interview with Shannon from Nike that sort of revved things up big time. How did it get to that point? Is it because of police numbers? Is that part of it?
No, I'll talk about police numbers in a second, but retail shop theft is a growing trend right across Australia. We're seeing an increase in numbers in every jurisdiction. I was in a meeting with all the other commissioners from around Australia and New Zealand just last week, and we're talking about the challenges and issues that we're all facing, and retail theft is right up there across every jurisdiction. So the question for us is, what is happening in our community or in our society that creates a mindset in people that this is okay to do? You know, what is it that leads up to a person walking into a shop, threatening staff members, stealing, you know, wantonly stealing, taking goods? There's got to be some analysis of the symptomatic causes that result in people committing these offences. What is it that makes them think that they're going to get away with this?
Mm. Well, is part of it the fact that they do get away with it?
Oh, absolutely. There's
like the laws,
a perception of consequence. You know, if there's no sense that you're going to be held accountable for your behaviour, then there's no incentive not to do it. So,
well, Sean Fuser just told us he's been doing courts for 30-odd years in Adelaide. He can't remember ever seeing a shoplifter get jail time.
No, I did hear that, and I'm not in a position to be able to comment whether anyone has, but in the context of people's perceptions about what's serious, I think shop theft is not considered serious across, you know, many people's views. So it's dealt with in that manner. And I think there are some reasons for an increase in shop theft that we're probably all aware of. You mentioned the cost of living crisis. There are factors that will compel people who might not ordinarily steal to steal, but I think there are broader issues at play here that result on additional pressures on police to have to put police officers into locations that historically we haven't had to have them. Mm. You know, the commitment we've made to increasing a policing presence in the Rundle Mall area, it's not a new thing. We've always had police operating in that location, but it's our obligation also to respond to people's fear of crime, and a strong police presence provides some reassurance and probably provides a deterrence. But we can't keep pushing police officers into every different location where we see a surge in some sort of criminal activity. We did it for North Terrace and it was very successful. We're doing it in Rundle Mall. We already have police officers focused on shop theft. This is a different thing, but the protests we have for the Israel-Palestine issues, you know, that's every time there's a protest, quite often we're not advised. We're looking at about 60-odd police officers being deployed from other duties to ensure a safe environment for those people who are protesting and those who are in the vicinity of the protest. There are finite resources within the police, and we spread them as deliberately as we can, using intel, and getting the best return on that investment.
And every time someone glues their bum to the road outside Santos,
that's another bunch of police officers, plus, you know, ambulance officers, fire, they're there as well. This is a distraction of our resources from planned activities. So
that sounds like that's a particular frustration of yours at the moment, the protest actions.
Well, it's a massive drain on our resources. Now, you can't be everywhere at the same time. And we need to make decisions about where we can get the best value in terms of ensuring public safety when we deploy our police, and we have an obligation to ensure a safe community. So it is challenging.
Can we just go back to Rundle Mall for a moment? But it sounds like your assessment, having chatted with other police commissioners around Australia, is that there's a broader issue that right across the country that's leading to more shop and retail theft. So is your, the assessment then, there's nothing special about Rundle Mall? There's no particularly negative element that's moved in? It's not got anything to do with the population of shoppers in the mall being reduced in, over the course of the week? These are just some of the theories our listeners were putting forward. You don't think it's any of that? It's just we're talking about Rundle Mall, but we could as easily be talking about Tea Tree Plaza.
Absolutely, we could. Okay. And our view, based on our engagement with retailers and the National Retailers Association, is that shop theft is significantly underreported. So it's not just Rundle Mall. It's every sort of major shopping precinct. It's liquor outlets are significantly vulnerable. We see a lot of theft of liquor from liquor outlets. It's an emerging issue that needs to be addressed, not just from a policing point of view. Forgive the use of the phrase, but we're like the ambulance at the bottom of the cliff. We come when everything else has not worked and people decide to commit crime. So, yeah, we're dealing with this as best as we can, but I think there are other things that have to happen to ensure people experience consequences. And we're trying to stop people from getting to a point where they think it's okay to do it.
Mm. I guess assaults on police officers fit into that category. It's something that we spoke about a number of years ago. I remember when the laws changed, there was a big police campaign, quite effective in getting police officers better protected. We've had another case, though, allegedly, where a police officer was spat on and an arm was broken in an altercation earlier this week.
Yeah, that's an interesting scenario. No one's been charged with the injury to the police officer who broke her arm.
Do you know why?
Well, the circumstances were that there was no... Well, I've only been advised that, and I've asked for further information on this as to whether there are any offences that we should be exploring, but the police officer was intervening and has slipped on some of the rubbish and debris that was in Hindley Street and has landed on her arm. Now, I think I know what you're going to say.
Yeah,
that police officer would not have broken their arm if they didn't have to respond to the disgusting behaviour of people in Hindley Street.
100%.
You know, this is what we see when hard-working mums get out there and start behaving like idiots in Hindley Street.
Surely you lose the benefit of the doubt. If you started the issue that caused the police to come out and then they get hurt...
That's the question I've asked. Is this police officer, the only reason she broke her arm was because she was responding to an incident involving violence in Hindley Street. So I've asked that question.
So that's like the old stuff with the coward punch legislation, where you used to be able to get off if you punch someone in the head and then they fell down and knocked themselves out and died from a head injury from landing on the gutter. It was sort of regard. Well, that's sort of the gutter's fault.
Yeah, it's cause and effect.
Yeah. Well, so, she wouldn't have broken her arm if not for that. All that other stuff, I would have thought.
Unfortunately, we see this type of behaviour in our entertainment precincts day in, day out. It is a consequence of alcohol, illicit drugs, late-night activity. It attracts a certain type of people. Most people go there, they have a good time, and they go home. But there is that element that don't know how to control themselves, and they cause problems for other people, and they put other people in harm's way.
What? How did you feel as a police officer, though, reading to this sort of suggestion that somehow, in the context of the hard-working mum who was there celebrating having the babysitter for the night, we know it's all before the courts, and she's probably going to argue her innocence. But the idea that spitting on a police officer is not regarded as really that serious.
Oh, we take it seriously, and we've had. That type of behaviour is considered to be assault. And because it's against an emergency services worker, it's an aggravated assault. We take it very seriously and we'll be looking to prosecute the person for that behaviour.
Good.
Yeah, absolutely.
Good. Commissioner, always great to have you in. And we'll catch up again in a month or so and enjoy the growing grandparent role.
Good on you guys. Police Commissioner Grant Stevens, our guest in the 5AA Breakfast Studio. We're the boys from the bush and we're back in town. All right, it's time to check traffic. Thanks to Keyser. If you're tired of back pain, try Keyser. Kieser.com.au.
Thanks, Will. At Bedford Park, three-car collision on the Southern Expressway at the Aylifs Road off-ramp, seeing delays inbound there. Another collision at Glen, Paynham Road near Glenburn Road, got really solid delays coming into the city as well. And Chain of Ponds, a car roll over on Torrens Valley Road near Gorge Road. Also delays at Erbray with a crash, Fullerton Road at Kitchener Street. We're quite busy at the moment, Greenhill Road at Unley Road, with a camera, Warren Road at Burtwood. Fill up with Shell V-Power 98, the premium fuel designed to deliver greater efficiency and improved performance. It's a decision you can feel good about. Details online. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
You deserve your life-changing moment. You deserve life-changing care. You've only got 7 days to buy your tickets in the Hospital Research Foundation Home Lottery. You could win the fully furnished $3.6 million Scott Salisbury Grand Prize at Henley Beach. Plus, your tickets stay in more than 12,000 draws, giving you a 1 in 15 chance to win. Hurry! Deadline March 27. Life-changing prizes, life-changing impact. Homelottery.com.au. License M14493.
Are you thinking about a sea change? Where you can walk to the beach and be part of a close community? Think Oakford Homes at Encounter Bay. You can live in a brand new low-maintenance home with all facilities close by. Fixed-price turnkey packages, flat land, ready to build. Move in now or invest for the future. Oakford Homes at Encounter Bay. Come down for a drive and look through our display village and see why stage one is nearly sold out. Oakford Homes, a statement of quality. oakfordhomes.com.au.
When you're a market-leading builder like Regent Homes, you never rest on your laurels. It's why Regent Homes is South Australia's only builder offering 3D virtual reality technology in their Envision Design Studio. At your first design meeting, you'll walk through your home in virtual reality. It's a wow moment, enriching your experience so you can make the right design choices from the start. Regent Homes. Innovative design, elevated living. Visit regenthomes.com.au.
How awesome! Mawson Lakes Volkswagen has plenty of Tiguans and Amaroks in stock. Tiguan Allspace is a 7-seater with plenty of room and plenty of smarts, featuring auto park, adaptive cruise control and lane assist. And the latest generation Amarok has a big 1-ton payload and 3.5-ton towing capacity. But inside, you'll get all the comforts of a luxury vehicle. There's plenty of stock that must go. Hurry in for a deal. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen, Salisbury Highway, just a short drive from the city.
See movies how they should be seen. Hear movies how they should be heard. All on the big screen with Quake Sound at Wallace. And now you can see them for less and enjoy candy bar discounts and other special member offers and freebies. Simply become a My Wallace member today. It's free, it's easy, and it's full of benefits. Go to wallace.com.au and click on Join My Wallace today. Wallace Mitcham, Mount Barker, Noolunga and the Piccadilly. South Australia's home of big screen magic and entertainment.
Here at 5AA, we're all about supporting local. Barossa Valley Chocolate Company is open every day, including the Easter long weekend. Barossa Valley Chocolate Company. Enjoy artisan chocolate, cafe dining, wine tasting and more. 5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube. Ray White Business Sales. Business people selling businesses. Go on, touch base, search RWC Business Sales.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Well, as is often the case, we sit around and have a chat with the police commissioner after his segment, but during the ad break then we realised a lot of what we're talking about would be of actual valuable information for our listeners. So we didn't let you go, Commissioner. Thank you for sticking around, because we wanted to share publicly some of the stats you've got about Operation Measure that's going on at the moment, because it couldn't be more pertinent to what's being discussed.
Absolutely, and I think it provides some reassurance to people that we're not sort of sitting around waiting for things to explode before we act. We've had this operation called Operation Measure in place since March 2022. And the purpose of the operation is to target recidivist retail shop theft offenders, work with the retail community to introduce prevention tactics and to target harden these facilities and these premises, and to make sure that we are acting on the best information available. And since March 2022, there's been something like 1,287 arrests or reports for shop theft, and we are, like I said, targeting those people who are repeat offenders. The program, the operation, is really highly regarded by the National Retailers Association, and it's won an award 2 years in a row, 2023 and 24, from the Australian Fraud Network for Best Retailer and Police Collaboration in Australia. So, just as a reassurance, it's not about just going to reports of crime. It's about actually engaging with the retail community, retail sector, making sure that we're focusing our efforts in the right place and that we're working with the sector to reduce the opportunities for these offenders and target the ones who are actually causing problems. And we're using intelligence and technology to do it as well, so we pick up the right people.
That's good to know. Good stuff. Good to share it with the listeners.
This time we will let you go.
Thanks, guys. See you next time.
For Lee Kirshner and Grant Stevens. We did play the bit of Lee Kernaghan a moment ago, and Daryl was the fastest to dial 8223-0055. Morning to you, Daryl.
Hey, Dave and Will, how are you?
Good, thanks, mate.
But not as good as you, because you are off to see Lee Kernaghan and his new tour, Boys from the Bush, Friday 19th of April at the Hindley Street Music Hall. Also, Daryl, you're in the running to win a meet and greet and also a Get a Lee Kernaghan signed guitar Friday morning. Make sure you're tuning in, mate, because we'll tell you then whether you've won the grand prize.
Yeah, we're big fans of it, so yeah.
That'll be a great night, mate.
Yeah, we've seen him back. We've seen him about 20 times, so...
Well, about time you got a freebie.
Yeah.
Good on you, Daryl.
Good on you, Daryl. We'd go to a loving home, that guitar, if ultimately Daryl wins on Friday morning.
As will the Smeg kettle. Now, we're going to have to do like the most rapid-fire rumours ever, aren't we?
We're going to get to those rumours in just a moment. Fuel Watch first, though. Find the cheapest fuel in an instant with the free RAA app. Download it today. The X Convenience, Main North Road, Prospects at $1.75.5. The OTR Marion Road Marion is also at $1.75.5, and just to keep it consistent, the Liberty Clare Street Port Adelaide, $1.75.5. Cheap spots all three. The cheapest diesel this morning is the X Convenience Main North Road Jepps Cross at $1.83.5. The Smeg Rumophile, thanks to the great people there at Smeg. If you're building or renovating, your first choice should be visiting the Smeg showroom at Deputy Distributors. Taste the difference with Smeg. Lucy's marked the cooler morning by wearing a jumper for the very first time today for 2024. So I think all the monikers this morning are all jumper related. For example, our first rumour comes from the quarter zip. The quarter zip jumper. Good morning.
Good morning. Nice to talk to you two boys.
You too, quarter zip.
You too.
What's your rumour?
I have a very strong rumour that from this Saturday, the public housing for people with complex disabilities will be changed, so that instead of having active supervision overnight, they'll be getting passive supervision. So the reason that is quite a problem is that my sister lives in supervised housing and has quite severe complex disabilities. And last week, the week before, when she had COVID, she vomited overnight into her CPAP mask. And if she had not had a person on hand to see that and to save her, they would have been going in to get her in the morning, and she would have been drowned in her own vomit. And that would have been a front page on the advertiser, like Annie Smith.
Well, it sounds like a really serious issue.
That is a very serious issue.
We'll raise that off air with the minister. That sounds dodgy.
Yeah, that is a very concerning rumour. Thank you for that. Let's go to Hoodie. Good morning, Hoodie.
Good morning, boys. Now, I was at a function on Sunday, and I was told that the South Road, they're planning on a new bus service. Now, this is the north-south corridor. So this bus will go north-south, probably cover the distance of 70 kilometres. Now, the people that are going to benefit are the local businesses, and also there's going to be less traffic on the road. Now, this is still in the planning stages, because, as you know, South Road is getting a revamp. So, because the way it is now, to go to a suburb, you have to go into the city and catch another bus. But this goes north, south, so it probably goes far as maybe Aldinga itself. So, they're looking at 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. For people working and stuff.
Thank you, Hoodie. V-neck is also on the line with a rumor. Morning, V-neck.
Good morning, boys. At least I'm not a polar neck.
Yeah.
And so the Woomera Rocket Range, as you know, runs from Woomera all the way up to northwest Western Australia. It was a couple of years ago, it was changed to RAF-based Woomera. It's always had an interest internationally from various spy networks, etc. The Prominent Hill mine that's actually located on the edge of the what was the Woomera Rocket Range, now RAF-based Woomera, when that was actually being sold, there was a lot of concerns from the government about it being foreign-owned, and so they tried to put things in place. Well, guess what? It is foreign-owned. a couple of people who I've come across who work at the Prominent Hill mine said that there are a number of large containers, if you like shipping containers, that type of infrastructure on the edge of the mine. Whenever there's a major trial on in Woomera, a lot of foreigners arrive and set up all their equipment on those containers and do a lot of data capture on the edge of the mine. So, following on from what the ASIO boss was saying, there may be spies here in South Australia.
Well, V-neck, thank you. What a range of rumours. We've got
something for everyone there.
Care, a lack of care oversight, infrastructure, and spies at RAF Base Woomera. Who do we like for the SMEG rumour for?
And it is while we're chatting, a big shout out to our good friends in Joslin. I know they're keen listeners to the program. Mm. I reckon let's give it to old Quarter Zip. Caller number one, Quarter Zip.
Quarter Zip. Yeah, that was a really concerning one.
It was. It was very serious.
And sounded very much in the know as well.
Yeah, totally. Mm. What is a Quarter Zip jumper?
I think it's what Lucy's wearing right now. Quarter Zip, see? Goes up the top quarter of the jumper. Okay. And so Sam Dado.
Sam's got one on too.
It's Quarter Zip Day. I've never heard it called Quarter Zip before, but it makes perfect sense when you see it. Thank you, models. Thanks to all of our callers too. Building or renovating, your first choice should be visiting the SMEG showroom at Debney Distributors. Taste the difference with SMEG. That is all from us. Matt Pantelis is taking over after 9 o'clock, and we'll be back tomorrow morning from 6.